the display of indoor fireworks goes up. Mike Riley leads the teams out. The roof is on. The din is on. The match is about to get underway, but Bernie, again, we applaud the Millennium Stadium Cardiff for putting on a spectacle such as this. There's little Rebecca Lawrence leading the team out. Gareth Southgate holding her by the arm. They're walking now towards the centre circle where the two teams will line up side by side. And this is one of those moments that, as a commentator, you can see on Century, it is a privilege to be here.
Definitely, without a shadow of a doubt. Magnificent atmosphere. Let's hope it's a magnificent game. And let's hope we can bring that elusive trophy back to Teesside.
Yes, the Middlesbrough team, all in red, standing just in front of us here. And having a little look up, we can see there Danny Mills having a smile. And Bolo Zenden, whose goal in the semi-final, helped Middlesbrough here. And for Juninho as well, standing on the end of the line there. Just a little smile across the face of the Samba star. And now the teams are going to be presented to the dignitaries today. The chief guest is Mark Hunter, who's the Marketing International Development Director of Coors Brewers Limited. Right Honourable Sir Brian Mawhinney, MP, Chairman of the Football League. And Anthony Pitchin, who's the winner of the Children in Need charity auction, are being presented to the two teams. And the dignitaries start along with the Bolton team, and then they'll move along to the Middlesbrough team. And Bernie, you stood in a line and shook hands with dignitaries. Do you listen to what they have to say or not? Do you shake hands and say thank you?
You're just focusing on the game, to be honest. You know, you're purely focused as a player to try and beat the opposition. And I'm sure the Middlesbrough players, although it's nice to shake hands with these guys, they just want to get me underway.
Sir Brian Mawhinney is now moving along the line towards the Middlesbrough team and shaking hands there with the Middlesbrough mascot, Rebecca Lawrence. And Gareth Southgate is now guiding the dignitaries along the line, introducing all of the Middlesbrough players. And once the dignitaries have concluded shaking hands, Juninho there shaking hands, Ugo Eyog as well, all of the Middlesbrough substitutes. And then the national anthem will be led by Lawrence Robinson. And Gareth Southgate just concluding now the introductions of all of the Middlesbrough players to those dignitaries. It's a very special match day programme indeed in Century. It's the Carling Cup final on this Sunday afternoon. It's a leap year.
I tell you what,
Middlesbrough about to take a leap forward.
I hope that smoke clears up. I thought I was back in Teesside for a minute. I am joking.
Yes, the Lions have now been concluded of the shaking hands with all the players. And for this Carling Cup final 2004, the national anthem is now going to be sung. And we're going to be led in that by Lawrence Robinson. So all of the fans have to be upstanding. And the national anthem before the teams will peel away to begin their final preparations. And we hand over now to Lawrence Robinson, who's going to lead us in the national anthem. Teams are just about ready to get on with things. Gareth Southgate yelled out, bawled out there the national anthem. But in many respects, Bernie, this is a Middlesbrough team made up of players far from the Isles of Great Britain. So go through the Middlesbrough team, please, and the formation.
Yeah, it'll be a 4-4-1-1 formation. We've played it throughout the season. Matt Swanson goal, Cadrian Mills, the two fullbacks, Eyog and Southgate back together as a partnership at the heart of the defence. In midfield, Zenden will be on the left, Mendy to right, and in the middle, two battling midfielders, Deriva and George Boateng. In front of the midfield, Juninho, and up front, Joseph Jobs.
And for Bolton Wanderers, well, Jussi Jaskalainen is the goalkeeper. A back four reading right to left of Nicky Hunt, Emerson, Tom, Bruno and Gotti, and Simon Charlton. In the midfield, right side of midfield, Kevin Nolan. Left side of midfield, Yuri Diokayev. Then Per Fransson and Ivan Campo at the heart of the midfield. Gigi Okocha and Kevin Davis will be the two strikers. The subs for Bolton, Kevin Poole, Anthony Barnes, Stelios Xenokopoulos, Henrik Pedersen and Javi Moreno. And for Middlesbrough, the subs, sub-goalkeeper is Bradley Jones, then Chris Rigotts, Michael Ricketts, Massimo Macaroni and Stuart Downing. The match officials standing on the centre spot at the moment, Gareth Southgate, captain of the Borough, JJ Okocha, captain of Bolton Wanderers, about to go through the final moment of the tossing of the coin. And the cameras for the present time focusing on Juninho. He said, Bernie, in the build-up on Century, a Carling Cup winner's medal for Middlesbrough would mean as much as a World Cup winner's medal for Brazil.
And why not? I mean, he's never won a medal in this country. He's been here in three occasions.
Yes.
He's been in, what, four finals? And he deserves a medal. And this season, and we see McLaren left him out early doors. A lot of people were surprised by that, but he's come back. His head never went down. He's come back into the fold. He's been in brilliant form. He's scored a fine goal against Arsenal. And he's played a major part in getting us to this final.
And let's pop down again to Gary Phillips now. Touchline reporter. Gary, who's getting rid of the covering from the centre circle. The smoke hasn't as yet cleared, but that was some build-up to what we hope will be a terrific Carling Cup final.
Absolutely fantastic. It doesn't have got the fans going as well. And then I just hope that the football is just as good as the early entertainment, because I tell you what, if it is, the fans are certainly welled up for it now. Just sitting down by behind the Borough fans, and they're totally up for it. And I've been watching the players looking. Gareth's out there now. He's going around each and every one of the players. He's going, come on, this is our chance to take some silverware back to Teesside. Shaking hands with George Boateng now. He is a true leader. He is a true captain. And I tell you what, he's gelled those players together. That's a team out there that want to win this trophy.
Yes, very much. Thank you, Gary. I can see Gareth Southgate now. Patting Frank Cadreau in the back. The captain, Bernie, has gone round, as Gary said, everyone
every
of the Middlesbrough players.
He does it every week. That's his makeup, and he's certainly a great skipper, and let's hope he's holding that trophy aloft. But looking at the teams and looking at the wide positions,
yep,
I think the vital areas today, Zenden and Mendieta have to be at the best, because Jock here will be up against Zenden. Nolan, who's a top scorer with 10 goals, which is no mean feat for a midfielder, against Mendieta. For me, that's going to be one of the key battles, or two key battles, here this afternoon.
Shrill whistle of match referee Mike Riley gets the 44th League Cup final underway. Bolton Wanderers all in white, attacking right to left as we look towards the north stand, as Jaskalainen's clearance skews out of play into the
good
second tier
down
over on the far
good
side.
And
Middlesbrough attacking left to right, that's towards the Bolton Wanderers end of the stadium. And it's a Middlesbrough throw-in out on the left-hand side of play. Frank Cadreau, whose penalty in the penalty kick shootout against Spurs in the quarter-final was so decisive, takes the throw for Joseph Job, close to the corner flag. And that ball rather rolls out of play. And I thought at first it was going to be a corner, but it's not. It's going to be a goal kick, and Juski Jaskalainen is going to take it. The two teams have met once already this season, and that was in the Premiership back at the Reebok Stadium in September, and Bolton Wanderers won that game by 2-0. But as Bernie's already said on Century, that game will mean very little this afternoon here in the Millennium Stadium. JJ Okocha, Nigerian international on the near side, goes to the floor, and referee Mike Riley indicates that's going to be a free kick as George Boateng went into the challenge. Borough defending the north stand, where all their supporters are congregated in the stadium, and this free kick near side. You do sense the opening exchanges will be a little bit tense. We're 90 seconds in, and the smoke from the pre-game pyrotechnics haven't as yet cleared around the arena as the free kicks into the area. Campo gets a touch, and that's knocked out by Frank Cadreau to the near side of the penalty area. And it's Danny Mills on this right-hand side of play, the Middlesbrough right back on loan from Leeds United for a period of a year, and Borough fans hope it'll be extended longer. And he launches the ball down the pitch. Joseph Job beaten in the air, but he's Mendieta. Look at Bola Zenden, left-hand side. Zenden charging in the penalty area. Zenden onto his left foot. Job scored! Joseph Job scored for the Borough! What a start! What a start for the Borough! 2 minutes into the Millennium Stadium. The smoke hasn't cleared, but Borough are going clear. And it's Joseph Job. It's Bolton nil. It's the Borough one. And that comes under the heading. Terrific start for the one Job on Teesside.
Absolute dream goal. Mendieta, lovely vision. He played it outside left his ending. He played it into Job, and Job with a simple tap-in. And that was a fantastic goal. And it was a great move. We have them open.
And what a start. Gary, let's go down to you. Terrific start.
Really fantastic. The manager's just out there. He said, calm down, don't lose it. Great ball, though, by sending into Joseph Job. Dream ball. He couldn't do anything else but hit the onion bag. Great start for the Borough.
It is. Terrific start indeed. That's the first Middlesbrough goal in a finally normal play, because the only other one from Fabrizio Ravanelli came in extra time against Leicester City in 1997. Bernie's still coughing a little bit because the smoke is still billowing around the what is the indoor arena here with the roof on, but it's 1-0 to the Borough on Century Live, right across the northeast, and a chip by Dorriver looks for Juninho on the near side.
But what a dream start, and what a lovely created goal. I mean, Mendieta's vision to see the runner Zenden up the inside left position, brilliant ball, and Zenden looked up, seen Job, and it was a 2-yard tap-in, brilliant.
And now Middlesbrough have the early goal. Bernie, you and I have been chatting all weekend about the importance of the opening strike. Cadre, left-hand side, along the left-hand side, Zenden, who's the architect of the goal, infield a couple of yards. Bolton clear it, but put back again by Cadre, but are dominant in the opening exchanges. But here's Ivan Campo, all white for Bolton, to JJ Okocha. Okocha, right-hand side of play now, pulling a few yards inside the Middlesbrough half, and it's Okocha looking to weave some magic with his right foot, then his left foot, closed down by Bolo Zenden, midway inside the Middlesbrough half, further forward than that, in the penalty area now. It's Kevin Davis with his back to your right-footed shot. Ricochets of Ugueyo, could go anywhere. Diokiev's nearly there.
Well done.
And knocked up by Cadre. And it's Frank Cadre's second crucial interception in the opening 5 minutes.
Yeah, good interception, good clearance. But you see JJ Okocha there pulling his strings in the outside right position.
4 minutes in. And if you just tuned in, you've missed some real drama here, because after a couple of minutes, Joseph Jobs for Middlesbrough in the lead. A lead they defend. Edge of the area now, though, Diokiev, blocked by Danny Mills, the referee's in the way. Diokiev in the box, onto his left foot, Schwarzer tips it round, magnificent big Aussie Schwarzer.
Well, it was a great strike for Diokiev, he got it, inside left position, he's inside the box for him, an acute angle, had a tremendous shot, looked decent for the right-hand corner, but great reflexy from Matt Schwarzer.
Brilliant stuff indeed. What a start to the Carling Cup final. It's been a mouth-watering opening 5 minutes. Borough have the lead. Corner to defend. Schwarzer gets there with a punch to the edge of the area, and he was under severe pressure and gets the free kick. Bernie, often we talk about the opening exchanges to a cup final being tense, nervous affairs. This has been almost attack and defence.
Very, very open. I mean, from the off, you go, what was the time of the goal?
2 minutes.
2 minutes into a game. It was a fantastic start, but tell you what, let's capitalise, let's try and get another one.
Yes.
Because if we get second, they've got an absolute mountain to climb. We can't allow them to get back in the game.
Kevin Davis playing at the top end of the diamond formation for Bolton. He's wanting the ball now, but it's JJ Okocha, halfway line. George Boateng leaps into a challenge. Juninho now. Gaiska Mendieta, right-hand side of play. Puts it into Joseph Job in the area. Job goes down. Penalty to the Borough. Joseph Job's got a penalty. We're in dreamland in Cardiff. If this penalty will be converted, it'll be 2-0. And already just 6 minutes in, you suspect, one hand on the cup. But it's a penalty, and the Bolton players are protesting around the referee.
Well, there's no good protesting. The referee's pointed to the spot. He did get... There was a touch. We'll see it again in the monitor. Oh, could have went either way. I've seen them not given, I've seen them given. Well, but hey, we ain't going to complain. We're Borough fans, we're 1-0 up. What a golden opportunity to make it 2.
It is. We are 6 minutes in. Our matchday programme on Century Live, right across the northeast, with Lanet Flooring Direct, top of the league for flooring. And it'll be Bolo Zenden with the responsibility from the spot. If he scores this and makes it 2-0, he'll get the freedom of the Borough and the chance to graze his sheep all he likes in Albert Park.
Don't mention sheep.
It's Bolo Zenden. The ball on the spot.
Back gamesmanship there with Jokiev.
Zenden against Jaskalainen. This for 2-0 at the Bolton end. Zenden takes it. Zenden scores. He went in off the foot of Jaskalainen. It went high into the roof of the net. And Middlesbrough have a two-goal advantage inside the opening 7 minutes of the Carling Cup final. It's Bolton 0, it's the Borough 2, and it's another sizzler from Zenden.
Well, it's an absolute dream start. It wasn't the best penalty kick. It didn't go for either corner. He put it down the middle, and the keeper almost cleared it with his right boot. But nevertheless, 2-0 up, and it's a fantastic start, isn't it?
Bernie, we're only 7 minutes in, but we can only lose it from here.
I'm beginning to think God's a Borough fan.
On a Sunday, right, well said.
Now, Gareth Southgate,
I'm sure he will.
That's a great start, Alan. It's a fantastic start.
As the ball comes out of play on the near side.
I could have never imagined. Several minutes into the game, we're 2-0 up.
Fantastic.
Never in a million years.
Middlesbrough Football Club 2004, Steve Gibson's 10th year as chairman of the borough. What is Steve Gibson thinking now? But here at Bolton in the Middlesbrough penalty area, Danny Mills knocked to the floor.
That's
the borough
got
a free kick.
Great decision.
Kevin Nolan went in a bit harshly there on Danny Mills. And the borough fans at the north stand end and right away around the rest of the arena where they've got their tickets just cannot believe it. They're bouncing up and down in the air. Let's join Gary if he can stop bouncing. Down to you guys.
Absolutely unbelievable. We're right in the dugout part where the team split. The Bolton fans are just absolutely stunned, open mouthed. It's like they've been hit with a comedy hammer. But I'll tell you what, the Borough fans are certainly behind them, and I'll tell you what, the bench are out and saying, come on, keep focused, keep going at him, keep getting at Bolton, and Steve McClam's not going to let this one slip.
Dorivet in the midfield area chips it beyond the Bolton back four, but there's not a red shirt there. Janino wanted it, in fact, short, and the ball is going to roll out of play. Century live right across the northeast for our good friends, Laminate Flooring Direct, always a Polish performance. I don't know, whatever you're doing this Sunday afternoon, join me in a communal pinch yourself. This is the final of a major competition. It's 2-0 to Borough. We're 8 minutes in. Joseph Job in the second minute scored. And then in the seventh minute, he won a penalty, which Bolozenen converted. And it really is dream time in Wales as Bolton tried to recover. And they do look stunned at the minute, but they get a free kick, put a push there on. I think it was Per Franson, and it will be a free kick for Bolton, midway inside the Middlesbrough half of the pitch. We haven't reached 10 minutes, and it's 2-0 to the Borough.
Everything's going my way. I mean, I said when it was 1-0, if we were to get a second, it would be an absolute mountain. And they've got a mountain to climb. It's not a long way to go.
JJ Kocha takes the free kick. Offside flag is raised by the linesman over on the far side. And Bolo Zenin gives him the thumbs up. Just going back to the penalty, when he thumped it, it hit the... I think it hit the ankle of Juski Jasulainen, went right in the roof. It was the power that took it in, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. But it wasn't the best penalty kick, but hey, it went in, and it's given us a two-goal cushion.
I remember John Hickton, the great Middlesbrough penalty taker, I asked him what his technique was. He said, I didn't have any, as long as it went in. And that exactly sums up what happened with Bolo's
ending
there.
You told me a story about Hickton for years, and he used to run to the halfway line with a load of sauce.
That's right, he used to run from Redka. Now, the white shirts of Bolton on the left-hand side, tried to keep it in through Diokayev, but failed to do that. And you look at, I suppose, Sam Allardyce will be looking at his big game players, the likes of Diokayev, a World Cup winner, JJ Okocha, to try and get them round from this. They must be stunned. Their game plan has gone completely out the window.
Out the window, dead right. Goodness knows what Sam Allardyce is thinking. Goodness knows what Steve McClellan's thinking.
And I keep mentioning, because you refer to him as the King of Teesside, goodness knows what Steve Gibson is thinking at this stage. But let's keep it all into context. We reach just 10 minutes of the final. As Jaskalainen comes out to the left-hand side of the penalty area. And his blue top and picks it up. The Bolton Wanderers team that have made their way through to the final. They've been in this final once before when they lost to Liverpool by 2-1 at Wembley back in 1995. Now Nolan looks for the run on the right-hand side. There's danger. The ball comes in the box, deflected out of play. Alf Gareth Southgate, and that will be the first corner of the game. And it goes the way of the Wanderers. We are some 11 minutes into the match. Middlesbrough have a 2-goal advantage. And Bernie's still clearing his throat from the smoke around the place, because the smoke hasn't as yet cleared, and certainly hasn't cleared from the eyes of Bolton. They've been stunned. Corner taken, right foot into the penalty area now. Headed on by Campo. It's a high one. Mark Schwarzer comes out to collect it, despite the extended right foot of Kevin Nolan. And you do think about the tears of 97 and the despair of 98 in terms of League Cup finals, and wonder if this February the 29th day of 2004 is going to be the start of smiles instead of tears in finals for the Borough. Joseph Job thought he was fouled there by Emerson Tone, but the referee says no. Gareth Southgate wins the header. Doriva, he was caught a bit late there. Janino, though, keeps the ball in play, left-hand side of play. Runs straight into the Bolton right full-back. That's Nicky Hunt. And it'll be a throw-in for Middlesbrough. And the Borough bench, I can just see them at the moment trying to take it all in. Gary, down to you. What's the message from the bench at the moment?
Don't sit too deep. That's what they're saying. Don't let them get on top of you. Play your game. You've got a two-goal cushion. Steve McClaren, he's just stunned. He's just looking around. Paul Barron, goalkeeper coach, he can't believe it. I can't believe it.
And George Boateng for Ugayog. Right-hand side, Danny Mills. And he was fouled by Yuri Diokayev. And Borough get a free kick a couple of yards short of the half line. The two teams have only met once before in the League Cup, and Borough eventually got a victory for that one, courtesy of a late winner from Craig Hignett, who was a great Middlesbrough servant in the 1990s. I'm sure that he's either here watching or listening in, as Zenden tries to prompt another Middlesbrough attack, blocked by Diokaye, but there's Gaisca Mendieta, Spanish Cup winner with Valencia. Juninho tries to get it on his knees, far side. Bola Zenden to Juninho. Juninho now just couldn't get it, it was behind him there, 30 yards out.
Free kick, Zenden.
Bola Zenden concedes the free kick, and the ball was ricocheting there a little bit, wasn't it?
Zenden was as sharp as a tack there, great interception, played it to Juninho, and obviously it was a free kick there.
What a year 2004 has been so far for Bolo Zenden, hasn't it?
I mean, he came in for a lot of criticism, as I say, Zali. A lot of it was justified, he wasn't doing it. But the last five, six games, he's been a big, big player for us, and he's been in great form, and he's scored a few goals. And long may that continue.
Jaskalainen takes the free kick, edge of the area. Kudrø gets there. And now Joel George...
Lack of communication.
Don't even not communicating, but Gaithka Mendieta helped out. Bolo Zenden. Job, Butter on the halfway line, tried to progress. It's a long back pass, though, by right-back Nicky Hunt for Jaskalainen. And goodness knows what Sam Allardyce is thinking at the present moment in time. Butter have a two-goal advantage and get a free kick as well, because Kevin Davis was putting his backside into Gareth Southgate there, and that will be a Middlesbrough free kick. Back home in Teesside, I think everybody at the Many Penny be saying, surely not, tuning into Century, 2-0 to Butter in a major cup final, but that is the score, and it could be better as Joseph Job leaps, but mistimes his leap somewhat, and it's from one goalkeeper to the other as Jaskalainen gets possession. Yes, it's our matchday programme with Laminate Flooring Direct, top of the league for flooring, and it's 2-0 to the Borough in the Carling Cup final under the roof here at the Millennium Stadium. Free kick given to Bolton as Kudrø rather mistimed his leap there, to the shouts of the Bolton fans who are regathering their voices and their thoughts after Middlesbrough's sensational start. Free kick, right-hand side. Diokaev is going to take it, and he'll take it right-footed, curls into the area now, beyond Campo, almost beyond everybody. There's a
free
push
kick,
there.
Offside.
The referee saw a push, and the linesman saw offside, and Danny Mills is applauding everyone to the echo there that Middlesbrough have a respite from that flurry of Bolton Wanderers pressure. Back down to you again, Gary. Just taking it all in the bench, I would imagine.
They certainly are. They're just talking amongst themselves and just saying, look, I would imagine at half-time, they'll just say, look, calm down, we can only but lose this. But I tell you what, the Bolton bench are just stunned. And Bolton, if you watch them, they're starting to lose their discipline a little bit with the referee. And that can only be good for the Borough, because they're getting really wound up.
Gary Phillips, now unique touchline reporter, as Mendieta tries to win it. But Patricio Kocher to the left-hand side. And it's up towards Kevin Davis, edge of the box. Ehiog with the header. And Borough defend right-hand side of their penalty area with George Boateng, who's been in sensational form this season for Joseph Job. Job, Middlesbrough's now second top scorer with six goals for the campaign. Two of them have come in the League Cup. Borough losing possession till Danny Mills gets it back and thumps it down the pitch. First time take there by Bruno Andreotti. You're right about the good closing down, Bernie, and Jaskalainen's clearances straight down the pitch. Gareth Southgate reacts to win a terrific header. Zenden back into the Bolton half. And it's Ivan Campo, former Real Madrid player, used to be at Valencia with Gaithka Mendieta, as Campo dribbles it out to the right-hand side.
Nowhere.
What size are his shorts, Ben?
Bigger than yours.
Bolton now on the right-hand side, just along the far side of play. Kudrø wins one header. Gareth Southgate, the captain, very close to the corner flag, thumps it into the
seating
far side. And it's going to be a throw-in for Bolton, who are trying to respond to Middlesbrough's stunning start. And I keep mentioning it because during the course of Sunday afternoon, I know people tune into Century. Job, 2 minutes after Zenden put the ball across on a plate. And then Bolo Zenden from the penalty spot after Joseph Job had been fouled in the area. And Mike Riley making the big decision and the right decision. Here's a long throw into the box. Campo tries to get there. Kudrø wins it. Juninho, edge of the area, stopped, and Bolton put it back. Southgate wins another header, and Zenden scampers out to the far side to make life a little bit uncomfortable. But here's JJ Kocher, right-footed. Oh, and that's overplayed. And that's going to be a goal kick. And, Bernie, was it just the Middlesbrough was so quick out of the blocks that upset Bolton in their rhythm, do you think?
I mean, there was no rhythm in the game. The game hadn't settled. A couple of minutes in the game, you find yourself 1-0 up. I mean, it was bad defensive play in Bolton's part, but we're not interested in Bolton. We support Middlesbrough, but looking at the skill involved, Mendieta, he sees the runner Zenden inside left position. Mendieta, glorious ball into his path. Zenden took a touch, whipped it across the face of the goal, and Joseph Job, back stick, 2 yards out, put it in the back of the net.
Yep.
Well done to all three. It was a great goal.
Diokaye, under pressure from Mendieta. Now Mills back to Mendieta, but Bolton hurried it up a little bit there with Simon Charlton. And it's up to Ugayok to come across and to clear it. As George Boateng now helping out, right back position. Again, strong work. Does he do as he gets the free kick? How many people describe Bernie as the less than pretty stuff, George Boateng? It's the type of thing that you as a player out on the pitch recognise, and sometimes the fans don't see.
Yeah, he's not the kind of player I'd pay to watch, but I'd love to play with him. Mm. I'd love him in my team. You need a George Boateng in every team, and he does his job very well.
And he wears your old number, the number 7 as well, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. Carries it well.
Absolutely. Borough free kick, right-hand side, Century Live, right across the northeast. A long free kick for Job, beaten in the air, but he's dotted a little cushion header for Mendieta, central midfield position. He couldn't make too much of that. And Bolton now on the left-hand side with Simon Charlton. Crossed the halfway line for the target man, Davis. It eluded him. And Gareth Southgate, Boateng. Terrific little ball for Bowler Zenden. Zenden to near-sided player. Onside, Juninho. Juninho scampering away right-hand side. Juninho looks up. Juninho plays it into the box. Oh. It's knocked over his own crossbar there by Emerson Tome. And that's a corner to the Borough.
And that was some ball. I think it was Zenden played out to Juninho. Juninho carried it. Looked up. There's a lot of bodies in there. Mendieta, Zenden, Job. And I'll tell you what, lad almost scored an own goal.
He did. Emerson Tome, former Sunderland player.
Oh, that would have been a nice way to go 3.
Mendieta to take this Middlesbrough corner in front of the...
What a great move.
Yeah, it was a terrific play. Now, it's a crowded six-yard box in front of Chaskalainen, who's raising his arms and making a protest to Mike Riley. In there, I can see Gareth Southgate, Ugayog, Frank Kudrow, who's good in the air. Hasn't scored yet this season, Frank. Mendieta takes the corner, swings in. Kudrow tries to get there, but the referee spots an infringement. I often wonder, you know, Bernie, in situations such as that, where the referee has been asked to go into the six-yard box to sort it out, that the referee will look for the merest of touch and give a free kick. Why not then just retreat out and say, well, OK, then, if you're going to make a bit of a fuss. But instead, the referee saw the opportunity.
We don't know what goes on in the referee's mind. Mm. They don't know the rules. We don't know the rules.
The laws, as Jeff Winter, Teesside lad, told me to refer to it. Now, Bolo Zenden busy on the left for Kudrow. Now infield for Juninho. Juninho seeing a little gap for Gaisca Mendieta. Back to Juninho again. Juninho tries to dig it on. It looked like handball there by a Bolton defender. But Juninho tries to feed in Joseph Job as the referee.
Zenden was a better ball. He tried to force it to Job, which wasn't a bad idea. But Zenden was in a better position.
It was Ngoti's final touch there, wasn't it? As Borough tried to force it a little bit. Now Juninho. And you do wonder, Bernie, if Borough can just keep on this two-goal advantage, what gaps may break away. But on the term of breakaway, here's Kevin Davis, who rolls Southgate, right-hand side, puts the shot in. Oh, it's gone in the back of the net. It's gone through Mark Schwarzer. Kevin Davis's shot has gone through Mark Schwarzer. And Bolton Wanderers have found a way back into the game. 21 minutes have been played. It's Bolton 1, it's Borough 2, and Kevin Davis... squeeze it in.
He's no right to score for that angle, Ali. Give me. Schwartz had a cap on, he could have threw the cap on it. Majorly disappointing. They've not been in the game. They've not had a kick. We've absolutely battered them. Strapility pose. Davies gets it. He looks up. There's not one right shot in the box. And he hits it from an acute angle. And it's a goal. No. Rubbish.
Well, Bernie, let's concentrate on this. I understand your frustration.
I'm a Borough fan, I don't just comment, I'm a Borough fan. That's bad goal.
Okay.
They don't deserve to be in the game.
No, but let's watch this, Bernie. Gaisca Mendieta. Mendieta on the run. Mendieta trying to play through the gap, but Joseph Job stayed where he was. And Gary Phillipson, let's go down to you. It is Mark Schwarzer soft and the hero. It's an uncharacteristic error, isn't it?
I'll tell you what, I'll be fair with you. I watched the bobble as it went through, and it bobbled just before he went to get it. Fair enough, you've got to get everything behind it, and it did bobble before it got to him, and I think that's what sort of threw him. But this has brought Bolton back into it. It's brought their fans back into it. Game on.
Very much so. So, Kevin Davis's goal there for Bolton, timed in the 20th minute.
I mean, Swartz had nothing to do. That could partly be blamed. Well, maybe he's lost concentration. I don't know, but it's a bad goal.
And here come Bolton again, clearly fired up by that. Edge of the penalty area, Nolan, in goes George Boateng. Terrific tackle. No, the referee gets the free kick. And now all of a sudden, Bolton is squared up to George Boateng. There are players in a melee everywhere. The assistant's running on from the near side of play. The referee's really got the sword out here.
I think it was Franson.
Well, I just thought that George Boateng went in to win the ball. There certainly was a bit of aptness. Let's go down to Gary Phillips, who's probably got a better view. Gary, down to you.
Yeah, there was quite a melee. The challenge, it looked like to be a fair challenge by George. Then something was said. George got up, and it's not often that George Boateng gets riled. He got up, there's a few players went in, a lot of handbags. There's a lot of tension on that pitch at the moment because obviously Bolton are absolutely gutted to be 2-0 down. Then they get a lucky goal, Borough gutted to concede the goal, and it's all happening out on the pitch at the moment.
As Per France is being called towards referee, George Boateng is getting a yellow card, and Per France as well. I must say, I think that was a poor decision by the referee because George Boateng quite clearly won the ball and went in. And then he gets pulled back by Per Franssen, and then there's a little bit of...
Then he clipped him, and Franssen swerved onto him.
Just a bit of after you,
George caught him before Franssen responded. Let's be fair.
Free kick to Bolton.
But Swanson must clear his head. His teammates must give him a G. Come on, Matt. We're still two goals up.
Well, 2-1.
2-1, sorry. We should be 2-0.
Yeah, everybody caught up in it. And we say it time and time again, Mark Schwarzer has been a big Middlesbrough hero.
Fan
I know you are, and he will know only too well that was an error that was uncharacteristic.
I mean, I've seen Walker, unless I'm making a couple of those in a week.
Yes. So let's bang our keeper, let's bang our team. 23 minutes have been played. Bolton 1, Middlesbrough 2 is the score in the Carling Cup final. Astonishing first 24 minutes. Who said cup finals were boring affairs? Not a bit of it. This has been terrific stuff. And Bolton have a free kick in JJ Okocha territory. Okocha takes it right foot, it spins it, oh, it hits the roof of the netting and goes over. And that was very close for JJ Okocha.
Well, it's inside right position, it's outside the box. And we all knew he was going to go for it. And he just bent, he whipped it in with his right, inside his right boot. I looked just for the right corner, but Swartz on that occasion had it covered.
Yep.
Nevertheless, it clipped the top of the net.
And it's an amazingly open cup final.
It is now, but Ali, we were 2-0 up, we were strolling, we had them in toast, and then a goal out the blue, and a clang on that's 2-1, and it's game on.
It is.
It's a real game now.
Campbell wins the header, halfway line area, that looked like a little use of the arm there by Per Franssen, the referee saying play on, as Mark Schwarzer being hurried up by Kevin Davis. Schwarzer with his right foot drops it into Bolton territory, and Gotti wins it above Janino, but Job goes there a second time under pressure from Campbell. Now Charlton volleys it down the pitch, and Ugueyo comes out towards this right-hand side to watch the ball go out of play. And it'll be a Middlesbrough throw-in about level with the edge of their penalty area on the right-hand side. You're listening to the Carling Cup final from the Millennium Stadium in Cardiff on Century, right across the northeast. I think this is an afternoon when nerves are going to be tested to the ultimate. Borough do have a 2-1 advantage, but the advantage is less certain than it was. Job. Tries to find Janino, but he's Doriva now. Mendieta on the halfway line. Janino's making a run. Janino trying to put pressure on Emerson Tom. Tom, oh, goes back a little bit carelessly for Jaskalainen, whose right foot thumps it down the pitch. And Danny Mills wins the header. Halfway line area we're talking about on Century. JJ Okocha gets in a tangle. Ivan Campo as well. Boateng tries to keep the pressure on. And it's Bolton with possession, left-hand side. Now it's JJ Okocha, Diokayev. Bit
well
short.
Tracked, George Boateng.
And Janino now, half-line area for Janino. And George Boateng for Bolo Zenin. Zenin, a long ball down the pitch. Angotti header, got to get a free kick. I'll tell you what, they're leaving the foot in, you know.
That's a cup final. What do you want them to do, stand back and watch? Mm. Let us give the compliment back.
As Borough get their free kick, 5 yards inside, or no, 10 yards rather, inside, on half of the pitch. Borough in their red shirts, left to right as we're watching, towards the end of the stadium that has the Bolton fans. Danny Mills goes up to win the header, bounces on the edge of the box, and Gotti clears it with his left foot for Kevin Davis, who chests it nearly in the path of Doriva. Now Gareth Southgate returns the ball near side, headed by Charlton Zipour. Danny Mills. Mills thinks about the raking shot, rasps over the top of the bar.
A shooting header, I think he's certainly done that. It was hanging handsome.
Put his foot through it. Now let's pop down again to Gary. Gary, I know you're a former member of the goalkeepers union. Has big Mark Schwarzer cleared his head, Gary?
I think so, yeah. He's a professional guy. He's made mistakes in the past and he's come back. And don't forget, a couple of minutes before that, he made a fantastic save from Jorkiev, putting the ball out for a corner. So he'll be all right. He'll be sorted. He'll just want to get another touch of the ball because I don't think he's actually had the ball in his hands since conceding the goal. But he'll be fine. He's an Australian international. He'll be okay.
As the Finnish international, Jussi Jaskalainen is going to take this. A goal kick for Bolton Wanderers. It's their fans who found their voice in the last couple of minutes or so. We're some 27 minutes into the first half of this Carling Cup final. A reminder, we're here until 5 o'clock tonight if we finish in normal time. And as soon as the whistle goes, 0-1-9-1-4-7-2000 with a simply red 4-0. Now, Joseph Chaub is making life uncomfortable out on that far side of play, but Wanderers get it back to Jaskalainen again. He's out to the right-hand side of the area, but I still have advantage as the benches watch on anxiously. Gareth Southgate didn't win that header. Kadri spoons it high, bowler's ending as he bubbles awkwardly with his left foot. And you need your big game players in cup finals. Ivan Campo, pretty much a big player, under pressure from one of the smaller players, Juninho. It's a throw-in for Bolton. On their right-hand side of play, Campo decides to leave it on this occasion. Edge of the box, we can see Kevin Nolan, the Wanderers' top scorer, the number four is there, but Kadri wins the header as he doesn't reach the edge of the box. Juninho again tries to lead with Campo. Wanderers put it back in the Middlesbrough area. Half-headed up by Gareth Southgate. Good tackle there by Doriva, but have got to be careful. Shot comes in. Schwartz has been, hits the post, and Schwartz makes a remarkable save on the return. As it seemed for all of the world, the Yuri Diokhaev was going to put Wanderers level at 2-2, and instead Mark Schwartz redeems himself.
Well done, Schwartz. Well done. Take my hat off to him. As Gary said, he hadn't had a touch up to this minute, but I tell you what, he was beat to the world in the first shot, clipped the post, come back. Well done, Schwarzer.
I thought Diokhaev was going to score there.
He should have scored. He should have scored. As an ex-centre-forward, he should have scored. And well done, Schwarzer.
And as a World Cup winner, he should have scored. Campo. Bolton quite clearly have been given extra impetus from the goal by Kevin Davis. But nonetheless, let's give credit to Mark Schwarzer. At fault for the goal, certainly, but he's produced a couple of terrific saves. And he'll be feeling a bit better now after that great block there from the Yuri Diokhaev efforts. Free kick for Bolton, left-hand side. Oliver Zhu was saying it was all over after 7 minutes when Borough were two up. Have been proved wrong. This is a big cup tie now. Okocha, the edge of the penalty area.
No, we can only throw it away.
To the right-hand side. Emerson Thome up in support of the attack. Has he shown too much of that far side? He has, and Borough looked to clear. And it's Doriva who's gone to the floor. And Emerson Thome just dashing back now. He got caught certainly out of position there, Emerson Thome. And it's going to be a Middlesbrough throw-in on the left-hand side. Level with the edge of the penalty area. Borough fans recovering from the shock of the Kevin Davis goal. We've got about 15 minutes to go before our half-time interval.
I tell you what, it's a nervy occasion, isn't it?
These are big games, Bernie. Terrific occasion here. Everybody who was involved in the setting of this Millennium Stadium, with the build-up, did their part in full. They really cranked up the atmosphere. We had a terrific start with Middlesbrough going two up, Kevin Davis pegging it back, and we've got, in every sense of the word, a great game of football here as Gareth Southgate tries to get it under control, nearly loses it, helped out by Doriva, who again does the dirty work in the midfield.
The way both teams are playing, you reckon there's going to be more goals, don't you?
You do, Bernie. And for all those neutral observers who wondered what a final between Borough and Bolton would conjure when they're used to seeing the Manchester Uniteds and Arsenals and Liverpools, this has been a great final for everybody so far.
Been entertaining so far. Yep. Thoroughly enjoyed it.
Well, apart from the one ball forward in the back of our net. Campo with his right foot from one end of the field to the other. Mark Schwarzer picks it up. And now he walks towards the edge of the box, throws it down the field. Juninho gets it onto his chest. The referee again is in the way a little bit there, but George Boateng for Hugo Ayog. Mendieta comes short. Ayog goes long with his right foot. We're trying to find Joseph Job. Job under pressure from Campo.
Well, push with Campo.
It looked like it. And Campo tries to turn and will produce a back pass to his goalkeeper, Jaskalainen.
Got a bobble there. Yes, bobbles, it took one there.
I think Jaskalainen's kicking overall hasn't been of the best. Here are Wanderers to the halfway line. Gareth Southgate
a free kick.
Concedes the free kick.
Knee in the back.
Just causing a problem, Bernie. I can see the central midfielder, Per Frandsen. He's bursting from midfield, isn't he? And providing an extra player up front. And really, Bolton do go at any minute to three up front. They do go 4-3-3 quickly. And Nolan, Davis and Diokhaev are the three. Here's a free kick, Bruno Ngoti.
Nolan and Davis can put their cell about.
14 minutes left at the end of the first half. Hope you're enjoying listening at home to our coverage here on Century as the free kick goes right foot in the box. Ehyog half deals with it. Diokhaev shot. Oh, it goes wide by a whisker. And Yuri Diokhaev should, again, have brought Bolton level.
But it's frightening to think when the ball comes his way, he's unmarked, and he's 6 yards out, and he gets a shot in target, and he should have scored. And for the second time, he should have scored.
I think that took a deflection, because it's going to be a corner to Bolton. So the corner count increases. 32 minutes have been played. Mark Schwarzer on the line, watching a crowded six-yard box just in front of him. You need the okay up to take this corner. A right-footed referee has he spotted something?
Ah, there's a bit of... It's Nolan and Mills and Campos in there.
It's all getting...
Ehyog.
It's heating up, Bernie, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, of course it is.
Corner kick still to be delivered then. Danny Mills is now having a word with the referee. Mike Riley is our man in charge today. And he's explaining his decisions there. Corner kick is long-awaited because Mills is still receiving a talking to. I think it was a kick, you know, on Danny Mills that the referee saw. If he'd seen that, he should have given Middlesbrough a free kick. It was Kevin Nolan who issued the kick. Now, JJ Okocha, right-footed ball, defended by Borra, every red shirt back. A left-footed shot comes through, a crowd spins in the box. Now Campbell tries to get it down, could throw a half, clears it. Diokka, Mark Schwarzer, magnificent, magnificent save by Mark Schwarzer. That was world-class. And he throws it out quickly to Janino. Janino now, darting in field. Bola Senden wants it. Senden is found, left-hand side of play. Senden, a couple of yards inside the Wanderers half, tries to find George Boateng.
We're waiting in the ball, go and meet the ball.
Simon Charlton, here's Diokayev. Diokayev in the midfield. Mendieta couldn't get it away from him. But I have to say, that was a great save by Schwarzer a few moments ago. Offside flag is raised against Kevin Davis. Let's go down to Gary. Gary, you're also a big fan of Mark Schwarzer's, and that was a big glove from the big Aussie, wasn't it?
He is a fantastic goalkeeper. He does have a glitch from now and again, but he will save you more than what he'll give away. Brilliant goalkeeper, fantastic save. But Bolton are all in the running. Middlesbrough just sitting back. The bench are going nuts. Just telling them, get the ball, keep possession. If you've got the ball, you can score goals. But Middlesbrough are not the racers at the moment.
Since the clanger, they've come right in the game. They've grew in confidence and stature. They've hemmed us in for long periods. And I tell you what, they've had three golden opportunities equalised, and as yet we've held them out. And two fine saves for Schwarzer. But we have to clear ahead, and we have to start producing at the other end. Otherwise, we're going to concede.
Looking at the stats, Bernie, Yuri Diokayev could have had a hat-trick in the last 10 minutes.
He should have at least one out. Definitely should have at least one.
Mark Schwarzer's denied him. It's been a great display of goalkeeping since the error. And now Middlesbrough look to push on there. Haven't really tested Jaskalainen since that Kevin Davis effort squirmed into the net. And they need to do that, because you do think that if they carry on putting themselves under pressure from Bolton, then they will concede another goal. And that's the last thing wanted 10 minutes away from half-time in this Carling Cup final of 2004. Bolton 1, Middlesbrough 2 is the score here in the Millennium Stadium, Cardiff, with the roof on. Danny Mills into a challenge. And it's going to be a throw-in for Bolton on this left-hand side of play. You just look up the pitch, though, and you see Janino, and we see Job, and think, if Bolton do overcommit and Borough on the counter charge, the game is ideally set up for them. Our Wanderers are throwing everybody forward here for this long throw, which JJ Okocha is going to take. Emerson Tome is coming into the penalty area, the tall central defender. Okocha takes it, arcs into the box now. Danny Mills gets ahead of that one. Kudre, oh, he loops back. That's cool from Frank to Mark Schwarzer.
I thought he was going to concede a corner, but it was lovely bit of skill, a cushioned header back into the hands of Mark Schwarzer.
And Mark Schwarzer been involved in a lot of things this first half. One thing he won't want to remember, but there's been many things that he's done to keep Middlesbrough in the lead here. Danny Mills with his right foot. Ball bounces out of play, throwing for Bolton. Do you take my point, Bernie, that what we need to do is to get pressure somehow back on Jaskalainen?
Of course we do. We have to keep the ball better. They've stepped it up. Their closing down has been exceptional since they got the first goal, or their only goal.
Diokayev for the far side of play. The white shirts again stream forward. There's a look up, the right footed ball fizzed in, and Kudre with a header. Has it gone out? Senden trying to keep ball, right, trying to dash towards as if he was going to stay in.
When they get in wide positions, that causes problems.
Yes, the throw in for Bolton. Now it's Okocha. It's back to goal. George Boateng goes in. Wins the free kick. Kudre. Boateng. Mendieta. Mendieta tried to get it through a gap too accurately there, and
unaccurate
rather, but now here Mendieta. Mendieta on the charge. Mendieta, as Janino was clearly blocked. Oh, what a great ball, it's Joseph Job. Job now towards George Boateng, right-hand side of the box. Boateng, will he break open from here? He goes down. Mendieta shot wide. Oh, Mendieta, who scored a terrific goal many years ago for Valencia, but that shot went wide.
I would say George before Mendieta. George gets the ball, he's in a great position. Job feeds him in. For me, he should take a touch and have a dig. He tries to cut inside, dilly-dallies. He goes looking for a free kick, which was outrageous. Falls to Mendieta, total missed kick, and it's a wasted opportunity. Make the keeper work. I'm not saying he should score. Have a thought.
Well, I'm running out of paper for making notes of highlights of the first half. I'm just going to give up in a minute and throw the pen on the floor. Every bit has been a highlight. Now, Boateng for Janino. Halfway line area, Janino. Threads it through for Joseph Job. Job's on the charge now, gets between defenders. Joseph Job goes into the box as he pulled back there. And the ball is out of play, and it's going to be a goal kick. And Steve McLaren's incandescent with rage. Gary, down to you.
Steve McLaren thought that Joseph had got pulled back by Nicky Hunter. Clearly not. But McLaren, he just wants out there. He's getting a little bit nervy, and what he wants his team to do, because they're just starting to get back into it a little bit, because Bolton looked pretty ropey at the back. He just wants them to get on and have a go at them.
Pedro. Thank you, Gary. Pedro wins the head. It's awfully difficult to hear you down there, I know, with all of the din, but Gary's doing a superb job as always. Ivan Campbell, a couple of yards short of the halfway line. It's a free kick. Now he's wanting a card to be... That's pathetic from Ivan Campo. It really is, waving your fingers in the face and saying, book him. Look at him there, striding with his pot belly down the pitch. As
no need to get personal.
A free kick for Bolton.
They're like calling the kettle black.
And Gotti's going to take this. Right-footed. Mark Schwarzer decides to come for it. Schwarzer, oh, he loses it. And it's headed by Egyog and Senden. And Borough haven't cleared it as yet. It's Campo now, edge of the penalty area. Mendieta tries to go and win it. Senden, Mendieta, Borough on the charge now. Campo's trying to get back.
Four against four.
Campo's gasping. Oh, that's a rugby tackle. That really is... Oh, it's
that's a yellow card. It's Campo knew what he was doing.
It's like watching someone on the beach running for a sunbed when they're 50. That was ridiculous.
But I tell you what, yeah, it was. But looking back, Schwartz has to get those. Mm. That could have quite easily been 2-2.
Well, Ivan Campo...
Schwartz has blown hot and cold for me. He has to get them. And looking at that, Campo, you're a disgrace.
Campo's just blowing.
But his experience, he knows the score. He knew we were away there, but he'd overloaded it with a man over. And it's a bit of gamesmanship.
Cadre takes the free kick, looks for Danny Mills. Mills puts the header back inside the penalty area. Janino beaten to it by Bruno and Gotti's powerful touch. Now JJ Kotcher on the near side of play, launching in the Middlesbrough half of the field. And Gareth Southgate.
Yeah, he's given a late challenge, Mendieta and JJ Kotcher. I think Mendieta left his foot in there.
Well, he might have done. Referee spots it. You did as well, Bernie. It's our matchday programme on Century Live, right across the northeast, with Laminate Flooring Direct. Wipes the floor with the opposition. It's Bolton 1, it's Middlesbrough 2, if you've just joined us. Borough, great start. Chaub and Senden, and then Kevin Davis bringing Wanderers back into the match. Botan gets his clearance acrobatically, but those white shirts again try to get it sent. Oh, Senden concedes a free kick needlessly, really, and he got too close to Nicky Hunt, who turned him there. And a free kick for Bolton. 10 yards inside the Middlesbrough half of the pitch.
A similar fashion in which we've seen Campo doing.
It was 6 minutes away from the half-time interval. And Wanderers are going to commit players forward here. Yuri Diokaev rolls the ball. And the Borough fans are howling that isn't in the right position. Diokaev takes it right-footed. Free header, Gareth Southgate. Job tries to advance
shot
it.
There.
Halfway line. And Emerson Thomas, square ball. Mendieta tries to read that one, but it's whisked away from him by Simon Charlton. Okocha now. Got a block. It's going to bounce. Mills is timing his lead perfectly. George Boateng chests it down and tries to link into Mendieta. Boateng on the floor. The referee saying nothing wrong. Boateng gets up and sees Okocha in front of him. A little gap there for Nolan. Now there's Boateng into another challenge. And Wanderers come back to the half a line. George is having a little word with Mike Riley there about a challenge he thought was a foul of a couple of moments ago. Wanderers switch the play, though, and then revert back to their own half of the field. Wanderers, the losing finalists of this competition against Liverpool back in 1995. Middlesbrough twice in the final, losing against Leicester in 97 and against Chelsea in 98. Gareth Southgate waits for Cadre to, with his left foot, get a clearance. Janino to the far side. Oh, and he's seen knocked to the floor there by Bruno and Gotti. Free kick for Borough. Senden takes a quick free kick. Mendieta bursts forward. Jaskalainen gets it as he was overplayed the free kick. And I'll go down to Gary in a moment or two to get the thoughts from the bench as we're in the final 5 minutes of what's been a frantic first half in this Carling Cup final of 2004. Simon Charlton on the left-hand side for Wanderers. For JJ Kotcher. His right foot.
Where are we? We should be out there.
Drilled out towards the far side of play. And now in the box, Davis tries to dummy it.
Gareth Southgate.
Now, Dorivar, midway inside the Middlesbrough half. Ahead of him, Mendieta and Job. Played for Gaithka Mendieta. Job goes on the run. Oh, it's a well-timed challenge there by Ngoti. Zenon Sal. Look at Campo diving. Well, no, Campo dived there, Bernie.
I thought he caught him.
He saw the chance coming in, Campo, and put himself on the floor. We felt the earthquake up here. And Campo wanders off. As the challenge went in, and look, Campo, that's a clear fall. He just fell there, Campo.
Ali, you need new glasses. He clipped him, man. He got him. He clipped his right foot.
Free kick for Bolton. A couple of yards short of the halfway line. And Gotti takes the free kick right-footed. Schwarzer remains in the six-yard box. Now he comes for it, or rather Danny Mills decides to go for it. Put back in the box now, and George Boateng with his right foot.
Boateng.
Volleys it clear. I think Kevin Nolan's taken a knock there. The players are shouting
the
referee.
I think it was Ehiog and Nolan.
Yep. and the Bolton physio is running onto the pitch. It's Bolton 1, it's Middlesbrough 2. We've got about 3 minutes plus stoppage time left.
What an entertaining first half.
Great first half. And let's go down to Gary. Thoughts from the bench, Gary?
The thoughts from the bench. Just say what happened on the thing with Kevin Nolan. Ugo tried to jump over him because he went down onto the floor, and he got his studs on the back of his head, and I don't know if he's actually got a blood injury, but he did catch him as he went over. But thought from the bench, roller coaster. How do you legislate for something like this? You wouldn't have expected it in any scenario. The bench, I think, would be more than happy to get the lads in at half-time, calm them down, and make them start again from the second half. But Borough can't afford to sit back because Bolton will start picking them off, and you've seen that. Borough need to start pushing on, because I think Bolton struggle with pace at the back, and I think we could see Stewie Downing on.
Do you think?
I really do. I think Stewie could be coming on, and I think he would torture them.
Well, thanks, Gary. Gary Phillipson giving us the view from the bench. Stephen McLaren, I can see his face because it's on the monitor, the big monitors at either end of the
stadium. He's looking at what man.
He looks a little bit concerned.
On total control, then there's a gaff for the goal conceded, and thereafter, they should have been two or three more.
And the good news is, sorry, Bernie, that Kevin Nolan is able to come back on. We say good news, you don't like to see any player injured. And Bolton back to their full complement of 11. Gareth Southgate's going to try and win this in the air, but Davis just beat him to that one. Nolan who recovered from that knock, half got a touch onto it, but there's Bolo Zenden smoothly up to Joseph Job. Oh, he tried the back heel.
No, fancy flick.
Janino and Gotti read that. Okocha drifting into the midfield area now. And looking up is Per Fransson. He sees two white shirts to his right-hand side. The cross into the Middlesbrough penalty area. Mills.
Well done, Danny Mills.
A crucial interception. Janino. Borough don't clear it. JJ Okocha, 25 yards out from goal. Right foot, Okocha, Mark Schwarzer behind it.
Fine shot by Okocha. Good save, Mark Schwarzer.
And Schwarzer.
It was a snapshot, wasn't it? One touch shot. And big Schwartz was well positioned, good dive to his right hand side.
Mark Schwarzer clears it. Job will rise. He's good in the air, Joseph Job. But there's Campo with the outside of his right foot into Middlesbrough territory. Danny Mills didn't get there with the first leap. Second leap, his header for Ugo Ayog. And Ehiog into the once. That was another push in the back of Joseph Job, which the referee, he just carelessly failed to spot. Campo with his right foot now tries to cause a problem. Ehiog clears it. Bit scrappy end of what's been a terrific first half. Doliver, though, for Zenden into Wanderers territory. For Janino, crudely brought down there. Free kick as Nicky Hunt went in. And Bolo Zenden's making a point. 3 minutes, a minimum of 3 minutes will be added on at the end of this first half. And always a sign the half has been entertaining. I was just about to check how long into it, and the referee sees the fourth official on the board for 3 minutes. It's been great, hasn't it?
It has been a very entertaining first half.
2-1, Middlesbrough lead.
A nervy first half, but enjoyable.
Frank Cadre making a point. Dorivep to Frank Cadre. Cadre looks up. Mendieta's gone into the box. Mendieta tries to leap there. Was there a one-wrist goal deflection? Kick. But no, it's going to be a goal kick. Mendieta got the final touch. What about Gary's point, Bernie, that he was making? He thinks that the bench may be tempted to bring on Stuart Downing sooner rather than later.
I don't see it, not this minute. Obviously, they'll have a talk at half-time. I'm sure the same team will come out again. But obviously, if Bolton continue to pile on the pressure, you need an outlet and you need a bit of pace and somebody that's going to deliver quality.
Danny Mills takes the free kick, quickly looks for Joseph Job. Job tries to get it under control, but awkward for Job. But he does really well to find Bolo Zenden, left-hand side. There isn't a red shirt in the Wanderers' area at the moment. Zenden tries to bring him Mendieta. Campo got a touch. JJ Okocha thumps it way down the field. And Gareth Southgate, his header goes back to Mark Schwarzer. Schwarzer rolls it underarm for Ugo Ayog to the right-hand side of the Middlesbrough penalty area. Borough lead 2-1 into the second of the allocated 3 minutes of stoppage time at the end of the first half. You're listening to Centre FM Sport, proudly backing Middlesbrough Football Club. Our good friends, Laminate Flooring Direct, top of the league for flooring. Mark Schwarzer into the Wanderers half, where Charlton brings it down. Janino comes across towards him and spoons it along the flank, where Danny Mills, though, can get involved. For Mendieta, did he keep it in? The referee says no, under advice from his assistant. It's going to be a throw-in for Bolton on this left-hand side. Into the final 60 seconds of the first half. Just to remind you, if we do finish at the end of 90 minutes and don't need extra time, goodness me, or even penalties, we immediately open the lines and we'll finish here at 5 o'clock this evening. If we go on beyond that with extra time penalties, we'll finish at 6. Either way, every kick, all the drama will be brought to you on Century from the Millennium Stadium in Cardiff. On February the 29th, it's been a pleasure to watch this game of football as Jasker line into the right-hand side of the box. thumps it down the field, and Gareth Southgate tries to get there. Davis wins the header. Ehyo gets the second header. Zenden thought he was caught with a high kick, and the referee agrees. He tried to play the referee an advantage.
Davis is saying his head was down, but his foot was up illegally, and it's the right decision by the referee.
And Burrow cleared anyway, Bernie, and it's going to be a free kick for Middlesbrough just outside the penalty area. The dying embers of the first half that's been really alive ever since Joseph Job put Middlesbrough in the lead in the second minute. Added to by Zenden's penalty in the seventh, but Kevin Davis's goal bringing everything back together. As Jaskalainen with possession, the Wanderers penalty area way to the right-hand side. Jaskalainen straight down the field. Danny Mills wins another header for Gaith Gamendieta into the midfield. Dodiva puts it wide. Dodiva, that's the final moment of an enthralling first 45 minutes in the Carling Cup final of 2004. And the first half ends, Bolton 1, Borough 2. Will be tacking their red shirts right to left towards the north stand where the majority of the Middlesbrough fans are congregated. A back four for the Borough, right to left to Mills, Ehyog, Southgate and Kudre. Midfield, Mendy at the right, Zenden left, Dolivar and Boateng central, and Chaninho just behind Joseph Job. The shrill whistle of the match referee gets the second half underway. Middlesbrough goal scorers Job and Zenden, Davis for Wanderers. And if the second half is as good as the first, Bernie, we're in for a treat.
Definitely.
Boateng for Job. Now Juninho. Juninho tries to burst forward. Mendieta's away to his right. Feeds in Gaius Mendieta. Mendieta tries to chip the goalkeeper and puts it right across the face.
No name in the ball. I mean, Job was in there as was Zenden coming in behind him. And it was a poor ball by Mendieta.
We're just 60 seconds into the second half. Just to underscore again, Bernie, as he always does, as will be awarding a South Cleveland Garage's man of the match, with Peugeot simply the best at some stage during the afternoon. Who will be the hero today? Right, first attack for Bolton Wanderers on the right-hand side. A cross bounces on the edge of the area. Diokaev lets it run on for Kevin Davis, who's peeled away to the left-hand side. Support coming up from Simon Charlton. Charlton, his left foot, hits the back of Mendieta. Charlton has another goal, puts in the cross. Danny Mills heads it out to the far side of play. Charlton above Mendieta. Davis tries to get inside the penalty area. Right-footed cross, Kudre cleverly lets it go beyond him. He dipped underneath it, Frank Kudre, and ends up as a goal kick for the Borough. It is good to see this, Bernie, in the second half. The both teams are attacking the respective ends of the stadium that have their supporters.
Of course it is. Yeah. Always good to see that, isn't it?
As Mark Schwarzer prepares to take this goal kick. 2-1 to the Borough. Who said winning was easy? If it was, everybody would do it, wouldn't they? It's just had to be the way Middlesbrough conduct their affairs ever since 1876. Let's hope they do go on to win this particular tournament. But life as a Borough fan has never been easy. It's always been a bag of nerves. And Gareth Southgate for Dodiva. Half-line area, Joseph Job couldn't get there because Ivan Campo.
And today's no different.
No. We were in dreamland at 2-0. But always suspected there might be a certain twist in the tail. Now, here's Campo. Back into the midfield area for Bruno and Gotti inside the centre circle. Towards the left-hand side. We're just 90 seconds into the second period, things settling down. JJ Okocha on the left-hand side, level with the edge of the Middlesbrough box. Back he goes a few yards. A run's been made by Charlton. Instead, it's Franson. 25 yards out from goal. Mendieta goes in to win
Mendieta.
It. Great tackle, guys. Mendieta. He in turn.
Yeah, he's playing.
He's tackled.
Tackle.
Mendieta claimed a foul, not given. The ball
offside,
in the box. Offside, Kevin Davis.
Offside.
And it's going to be Mark Schwarzer. So Schwarzer then collects it. Let's pop down for an early thought from the bench with Gary.
Very happy with his start. Looks a lot more settled. Steve McLaren just going out saying, keep the pace going, keep the ball, play it to the width, and just try to keep possession. And I think that's all he's trying to get across at the moment.
48 minutes have been played as Paulo Zenden. His header merely went into the path of Ivan Campo. Campo then for Ngoti. His back pass for Jaskalainen. And Jaskalainen with the outside of his boot clears it long. Davis wins the header above Gareth Southgate. Nolan stumbles. That's a handball.
Yeah, that's a good decision, referee.
Kevin Nolan
had slipped.
He had indeed. And then he kicks the ball away rather childishly. And Gareth Southgate can take all the time he wants. We're 49 minutes into the game, and Gareth Southgate prepares to take this free kick. Sam Allardyce watched the first half from the director's box, and he's sitting on the bench. Steve McLaren is there as well, as and got his head of that, nearly went into the path of Janinho. Instead, Simon Charlton swept up now. Diokaev gets away from Danny Mills. Terrific burst by Yuri Diokaev, a pace. 25 yards out from goal. And there's Kudrow, fellow Frenchman.
Frank Kudrow.
Wins it.
Diokaev.
Zenden now. Zenden into the midfield area. Looks for Mendieta. Read by Ngotti. Zenden slides in to win a challenge. Back come Bolton again with Okocha to the right-hand side for Davis. Davis gets away now. He's inside the penalty area. Goes down. No penalty. And Gareth Southgate for Gaizka Mendieta, and yards of space on the right-hand side to come forward to the halfway line, Mendieta. Then with the outside of the boot to Janinho. Janinho back to Mendieta. For Janinho again. Say, oh, that looked obstruction,
I tell you what, no.
And Mendieta's furious.
That abroad. Yeah, he dived there.
Well,
I don't like to see that.
Mendieta ran into the frame of Bruno Ngotti.
Well, that's all he did, run into him.
Free kick for Bolton. Midway inside. Their own half of the pitch. They're attacking left to right, second half.
Definitely no penalty.
No, it was a dive, wasn't it?
Dive.
Well, we shouldn't really say dives, is that construes referee should have given a yellow card. He just went down under the challenge. Now, Davis concedes the free kick.
He's back in the air, yeah. Good decision, referee.
Got a free kick just outside their own penalty area.
Back in it, yeah, Yog. I tell you what, Davies does well. As a lone striker, he backs in and he causes a
well, better. Bernie, you and I watched him play in one of the most memorable cup ties we've done a commentary on in century, which was the FA Cup semi-final against Chesterfield.
Yeah, that's right.
The 3-3 voted the best ever FA Cup semi-final. And Davis was a nuisance then, and he's been a nuisance this afternoon. But here, Borough trying to get an attack away. Mendieta, Job on the right-hand side. Job now for Janinho. Mendieta. Janinho, Borough midway inside, the Wanderers half. Janinho now with possession. Tries to link him with Job. Inside the box he goes. Mendieta tries to serve it up for Joseph Job. All a little bit tight and compact, and Wanderers push it out towards the left-hand side where Diokaev spins it to the halfway line. Davis serves it infield, but Gareth Southgate, lovely piece of skill by the Middlesbrough captain, but Joseph Job was still trying to reclaim an onside position, so the pass didn't pick up a red shirt. Instead, it's Jack Lyon, and there's one or two of the Borough subs start to warm up. Borough subs today, Chris Riggott, Michael Ricketts, Massimo Macaroni, Stuart Downing, the outfield players. Long ball edge of the area. Ehiog wins it commandingly. Doriva again does that piece of work in front of the back four that Chuffin doesn't recognise. Just gets it out. Wanderers on the near side of play. 2-1, it remains to Middlesbrough. Kudrow, Zenden, Frank Kudrow. Well, he's going to towards hitting the roof with that one. High one. And it's Mendieta may profit from that, actually, inside the centre circle for Joseph Job. Job steps away from Ivan Campbell. Terrific skill. Middlesbrough, a great moment here. And it's into Mendieta. Mendieta's inside the penalty area. Mendieta chips the keeper. Oh, he's put it over the bar. Goodness me. That should have been 3-1. And instead, it's still 2-1.
He had two options. I mean, it was great play with Joseph Job. Rolled his marker, left him in his way. He had two options. Play his end in a Mendieta. He chose Zen, Mendieta. And Mendieta should have finished it off. Off played and he's ending.
Well, here's JJ Okocha. And there's Kudrow combining with Southgate, and Davis hits the shot. Out come Middlesbrough again. Well, Bolton have really held a high line, and they could pay for this because Middlesbrough can countercharge. And Janinho to the right-hand side of play. Brilliant run by Janinho. Janinho dragging everybody towards him. And it's a throw-in far side. Gary, down to you. We thought that was going to be 3-1 Spanish goal for Gaizka.
So did we. Absolutely, so did we. I'm sat right with some Bolton fans right behind me, and they sort of thought, oh, no, this is going in. But just sailed over the bar. How disappointing. But come on, the Borough are making chances, and that's what we want to see.
George Boateng, then. Couple of yards inside the Wanderers half, right-hand side, sees Mendieta going on a run, trying to get Ngotti to come towards him. Gaizka Mendieta, Mendieta tussling for possession, Mendieta still, terrific player. Now it's Janinho, right-hand side of the box. In the air he goes for Joseph Job. Job tries to turn his marker and feed it on for Zenden, but a Wanderers boot got in the way. This is a good spell for the Borough. Some 7 minutes into the second half on Century. Zenden for Doriva. Doriva with his right foot towards the far side of the box, and it's half cleared. It isn't in fact cleared at all. Mendieta tries to hit it on the four. Back to Mendieta again, and Jasker Lainen behind it to make the save. And Mendieta is starting to pull a few. I know he should score, Bernie, but starting to pull a few strings.
He's getting pushed towards goal.
Boateng, but there's the Bolton. Number four, Kevin Nolan, tidily for JJ Okocha. Real danger here. Okocha attacking towards the penalty area. Okocha slips it into the box now. Mills slides in. Southgate gets it away.
Nolan tried to play in Davies with a clever flick. Didn't come off.
Century live right across the northeast. Borough commentary with the Glamour Foreign Direct. almost a polished performance. 2-1, Middlesbrough lead. Electronic scoreboard brightly at either end of the stadium. There's a left-footed cross, arcs towards the Borough area. Danny Mills goes up, Cadre with a positive header out, but here's the chest of Campo. Juninho tries to get there. Campo.
Oh, get up, Campo.
Dear me.
Yeah, it's the right decision.
Look at him there protesting. I think he protests too much, Campo. And it's a free kick for Middlesbrough, clearly outside the penalty area, as the Spanish barrel wanders away. And Mark Schwartz is going to take this. What have you made of second half so far? Just as frantic as the first.
Yeah, that's right, just as frantic, end-to-end stuff. And I say the next goal's crucial, hasn't it?
Mark Schwartzer takes the free kick. Job coming in from the right-hand side. Couldn't win it in the air. But there's George Boateng. Once more Wanderers with Campo. Little header back to Emerson Thome. Now Cadre in the centre circle for Bolo Zenden. Zenden tries to nutmeg Campo. Juninho goes for the ball. High clearance by Campo. Zenden tries to get underneath this. A little bit of a scrappy couple of moments in the Carling Cup final. Cadre just short of the halfway line. Zenden tries to turn his marker. Zenden gets the free kick.
Pull back, top there.
Nicky Hunt, wasn't it, tugging him back. Zenden complains. Zenden, who's probably been Middlesbrough's player of 2004 so far, some scintillating displays. Great goal against Leeds United. And a terrific strike against Newcastle in the 2-1 defeat. Well, it's 2-1 this time around, but 2-1 in Middlesbrough's favour. Some 10 minutes now into the second half.
It's
the Borough fans.
Tussle that Zenden and Hunt.
Borough fans find their voices. Doriva. Doriva from range wide. That's what you get when you listen to Bernie Slavin.
Have a go. It opened up for him. It's just a duff shot. But don't criticise anybody for having a shot.
No, of course not.
And Doriva. Every week.
Doriva, I've seen a number of occasions in training and, you know, hit a real terrific shot from distance. Let's see if he can do it this afternoon on one of the bigger stages. Cadre,
well done, Frank.
Header, chest by Campo. In goes Zenden. Zenden wins it once, twice. Now Juninho on the halfway line.
That's obstruction.
I thought he was. Lent in there by Emerson Thome. Free kick for Borough on the halfway line. As Bernie says in commentary on Century, the next goal is going to be, you feel, a crucial one. Borough free kick. Halfway line area. Gareth Southgate, foot over the top of the ball. What are his options? Mendieta coming in from the flank. Bolo Zenden in a centre-forward area. Job making a run. Southgate prepares to take the free kick. Right-footed. Arcs out towards Danny Mills' far side. Mills bundles it into the box. Back to Danny Mills again. Mills now for Juninho. Steps into the area now. Mendieta rolling his foot over the top of the ball. Mills chips it into the area where Joseph Job is the sole red shirt. And Job nearly gets there. Emerson Thome is very uncertain, but it goes out of play off the Cameroon international, Joseph Job. And it's a throw-in for Bolton on the right-hand side. And Hunt is going to take it. In fact, he's wondering what his options are. Delayed throw-in. 56 minutes have been played in this Carling Cup final. Still the destination of the cup itself in the balance. But Borough have an advantage. 2-1. Gareth Southgate for Juninho, and Gotti barges Juninho to the floor. No free kick is given. Joseph Job nearly gets it from Ivan Campo. And Campo back towards the goalkeeper. As Jaskalainen wanders to the edge of the area and with his right foot in the Middlesbrough territory. Ehiog wins a commanding header. Back to Wanderers we go then. Campo in front of the back four. Okocha, the referee says play on, as Okocha thought he was fouled there by George Boateng. Nolan now. Doriva gets involved. Ehiog back to Schwartzer, and Schwartzer's clearance with his right foot is composed and reaches the Wanderers' half, where Joseph Job tries to get it. Job now looked for a moment if he was going to get away there from Emerson Thome, but Thome recovered only just and feeds it into the midfield area. Then left-hand side of player, Simon Charlton. Charlton along the line. Would you believe it that Kevin Nolan's continued his run? Well tracked by George Boateng. Doriva, Juninho, Job's inside the Wanderers' half. Joseph, oh, that's a poor ball. Joseph Job gave it away rather carelessly on the halfway line. And this is a spell of a little bit of pressure building up from the team in white. And that's left-hand side, and it's Simon Charlton for Yuri Diokhaev. What are the options for Diokhaev? And his right foot curls the cross in the box. Back heel by Okocha, edge of the penalty area now. Shot hits the back of Bolo Zenden and ricochets all the way to Ivan Campo, midway inside the Middlesbrough half. It's hang on now, Borough. And the ball is played to the right-hand side, a little bit overplayed to Nicky Hunt.
It was a good idea, good run for Hunt, good intention, too much pace on the ball.
As Mark Schwartzer puts the ball down. It's the 44th League Cup final. I'd venture to suggest, Bernie, none have had as an exciting 58 minutes as we've witnessed so far.
I mean, it's been entertaining, It's been edge of the seat stuff.
Mark Schwartzer with this goal kick. to the halfway line. He goes no further forward than that. Job with a mighty leap, beaten to that one in the air, though, by Ngoti. Now Danny Mills, Mendieta, centre circle. Boateng claims a free kick. Referee says you've got advantage because Mendieta making progress on the right for Juninho. Juninho checks in field. Juninho away from one. Can he get away from the second? Still Juninho. Terrific run. Job back a few yards.
Advantage.
Doriva spreads the play intelligently to the left-hand side for Bolo Zenden. Zenden attacks, gets the ball in, puts the ball in the box. Campbell, oh, look at that.
There was no name in the ball.
Campbell.
I mean, again, Mendieta, Job, Juninho all waiting in the ball, but it went to a white shot, and that white shot was Campbell.
That's a throw-in for Middlesbrough. Bolo Zenden is going to take it. Up from the corner flag in the box. Joseph Job nearest at the edge of the six-yard area. Juninho is there. The long throw comes now. Jessica Lannan decides to claim it. That's a rather comfortable catch in the end of the Finnish international.
Juninho, the smallest man in the field.
It's rather strange, that. Jessica Lannan with his right foot knocks it deep. Just to underscore again, the Carling Cup final will be decided this afternoon, even if we have to go to extra time and penalties, unlike in 97 when we went to a replay. Here's Juninho now. Bright as always, Juninho, bubbling away along the right-hand side. Tries to find Joseph Job inside the box, and fortunately...
Good intention.
Yeah,
he good just intention. Couldn't... The ball wouldn't come inwards.
Just couldn't get it there. An hour has been played at this Carling Cup final 2004 on Century. Our good friends Lamnett, throwing directs, wipes the floor with the opposition. 2-1, it remains to the Borough. Kevin Davis, the scorer of the Bolton goal to the near side of play. Up from the corner flag, curls in the box. Gareth Southgate says, my ball, and a good header as well. Mendieta tries to chip it above Campo. Not the best option, you suggested, but Juninho again, hurrying up the Bolton players. There's George Boateng trying to help out, and Juninho nearly nipped it away from Simon Charlton, who's rather lucky to get away with it. Campo in the centre circle. Into a gap. Kadrir right. Oh, slides in rather rashly, Frank Kadrir. A right-footed cross, curling the box. Header, Schwarzer behind it as the header came in from Kevin Nolan.
Well, again, it was Hunt coming away on the right-hand side, getting time to get out of his feet and deliver a good ball. And I think it was Kevin Nolan headed, it was a team effort.
As the subs continue to warm up, Borough subs behind the goal away to the left-hand side. Bolton Wanderers subs away to the right. Anthony Barnes, Stelios Yiannakopoulos, Henrik Pedersen and Javi Moreno, the outfield players who are the subs for Bolton Wanderers. Now, JJ Okocha in the centre circle, trying to get away from George Boateng. Produced a pass to the far side. And it's Yuri Diokaev with his right foot. An appeal for offside against Nolan, not given. Now there's Doriva into one challenge. Danny Mills into another. Mills stumbles over Kevin Davis. Ehyog, though, completes the clearance with the aid of a deflection. It's a Borough throw in far side. Let's pop down and get a view from the bench from Gary. Down to you, guys.
Yeah, the gaffer's just sat down. He's absolutely chewed his nails. It'll be right down to his middle knuckles now. It's just a real scrappy game, backwards and forwards, and all he's saying out to the players is return the ball, keep possession.
And they're doing that now. Joseph Job cutting infield. He's got support with Juninho. Juninho now, midway inside the Wanderers half, out towards Bolo Zenden. Zenden under control, left-hand side of the area where he's dangerous. Chips it towards the far side.
Again, it's a poor ball. We've got shots in there. We're not picking them out.
Mendieta. It's Campo there.
We get three red shots. Pick one of them out.
You're right, Bernie.
Simon, ball.
Simon Chanskins is dreadful. Boateng tries to get there, then he slips on the surface. Okocha tries to profit from George Boateng's slip. Boateng goes back to the Nigerian international. Okocha,
there's
though.
Hunt. Somebody get Hunt.
And there's real danger here as Kadra gets the wrong side of Diokaev completely. It was a free kick, and he's conceded in a poor area because this is directly in line with goal, and it's Okocha range.
Yeah, it's a dangerous position. As you say, central, 25 yards out. But Frank get dragged for the left-back position in towards the heart of the defence. And if they clip out to Hunt, Hunt's an acres of room to go and take his on. But he's given away a free kick.
Free kick then to Bolton. It's, what, 25 yards out?
25 yards out, and it's just off centre.
Directly in line with goal. 62 minutes have been played. Referee's saying, do you want to take a quick free kick or wait for my whistle? And they're saying, we will wait. So Mike Riley then strides out the 10 yards, asks the wall to retreat another yard. And Campo is there, JJ Okocha is there, Yuri Diokaev is there. And now, you do sense, despite the presence of Campo and Diokaev, this will be JJ Okocha. Okocha then with his right foot, curls in, hits the wall.
Good wall.
The wall does its job there, didn't
good
it?
Good upright, compact.
Look at George Boateng chasing the ball down. Ngoti in the centre circle. And now, Doriva, couldn't work.
Four Joseph against
Job.
Three.
Here comes the charge of the Redshirts. George Job didn't pick out George Boateng.
And Juninho were gone.
Zenden, left-footed offside Juninho.
If he looks up, Mendy and Janino, acres of room. Well, they've all been attracted to the ball.
I think Bernie Tuney's rather making that point. Let's go down to Gary, because Gary, I think Bolton are sensing that they're going to want to make a change here, aren't they?
Yeah, Bolton are going to make a change. It's Henrik Pedersen is going to be coming on, and it's number 8, Per Fransson, coming off.
Thank you, Gary, as Sam Allardyce makes his first change in the cup final. And I thought that Per Fransson had an effective first half, but he hasn't really been it in the second half, has he?
He's died a bit in the second half, and Sam Allardyce has addressed that.
And Pedersen will go straight down the pitch to provide aerial support.
He's another bustling centre-forward,
isn't he? He's very similar, actually, to Kevin Davis. Bolo Zenden in a left-back position. There's a square ball to Gareth Southgate, under pressure, yeah, Southgate. I don't think Gareth will appreciate the pass in that position, but nonetheless, Butter getting to their right-hand side. And Danny Mills spins the ball down the pitch, but it's overplayed. Janino setting up the goalkeeper, stumble, and Jessica Linen just got there. For a minute, Janino actually thought he was going to get it.
It was a keeper's ball all the way here, there was a wee slip there.
Throwing is taken, Janino sends it back to Gaiska Mendieta. Mendieta in the box, loops in towards Job, and Jessica Linen stumbles and gets it. And just for a minute, Bernie, going back to it, Tuney thought he was in, didn't he? That the goalkeeper had stumbled.
To be fair to Janino, he didn't give up. You know, it looked the goalkeeper's ball all the way, but he carried on, getting in there. A wee bit of luck, he could have made it 3.
And the half continues. And both sides trade their attacking blows. And Wanderers on the left, into the box. Mark Schwarzer surely will come and collect it.
That's
he does.
Good, save. Good throw.
And a good throw as well to Bolo's ended on the left side for Borough in a defensive position. For Job, look at Mendieta, far side of play, but Job is under a bit of pressure for Kudre, midway inside his own half of the pitch. And Frank Kudre claims a Borough ball. Not quite sure what the referee is saying about this. But Gary, I'm going to go down to you because there's a Borough change, Gary. Is Michael Ricketts coming on?
Michael Ricketts is coming on and... just checking the number. It's Joseph Job coming off, and it is Michael Ricketts coming on, yes.
As Joseph Job gets a tremendous hand, he's running some of the ground.
I'll tell you what, Job's been a top man for me. He scored the goal, he got the penalty kick, he held the ball up brilliantly, he made a couple of opportunities, and that's a great shame. But the Clans are manager, Ricketts is coming on, who knows, he could go on and be the match winner.
Well, the reception from the Bolton fans is less than complimentary for their former centre-forward. But he did score against Bolton at the end of last season, didn't he, in a 2-1 defeat. And Michael Ricketts runs on, and scripts are written for players to score against their former clubs, aren't they, Bernie?
They are.
As Ricketts tries to get his first involvement, and Bolton Wanderers clear their lines at the expense of a throw-in. So we've reached 65 minutes. In the Carling Cup final 2004 on Century Line, right across North East with Lamont throwing direct. Almost a polished performance. 2-1 Middlesbrough lead. Borough have made a change, so 2-1 Bolton. How will it affect the game? As the referee just blows his whistle and gives Bolton a throw in on this near side. Borough are furious. They're claiming it's their way, but Mike Riley indicating no. It goes the way of the white shirts. And Campo can infield a couple of yards and then reverting it for Emerson Tome, who with his right foot. Along the near side of play, Frank Kudre watches it and Wanderers just about keep it in. Kudre gets there. That's a throw-in for Bolton on the near sides. Frank Kudre just checking. And Borough packing their penalty area. Michael Ricketts coming back. And presumably JJ Okocha will arc this in towards the penalty area. What a crowded penalty area it is as well. Ivan Campo urged to get in there. They're throwing the box now, headed out to the edge of the box. Mendieta tries to get there, put back in now, and a brave header by Gareth Southgate. Wanderers though on the halfway line with Ngoti. Oh, that's a poor ball. Bolo Zenden pounces on it. Zenden on the left-hand side of play. Janino holds it up. Where's the support? Look at Boateng. What a terrific run. What terrific vision by Janino. George Boateng on the right-hand side. Danny Mills come up like a train. Boateng, etc., tries to play in the box. Yeah, it's spliced by Okocha. If he catches that, that's a back pass, surely, Bernard.
No, he didn't mean back pass. Who are you kidding?
Well, they say he's a special player.
And you're a special person if you thought that was a pass back.
Jessica Linen clears it. You got the joke. Ehiog on the right-hand side. And he slides in there with Kevin Davis, and that's going to be a throw-in for Middlesbrough. But it's kind of a tough choice today, but a choice he'll make nonetheless for South Cleveland Garage's man of the match, with Rover simply the best. 2-1 Borough lead. We're ticking towards the 68th minute, and Danny Mills is going to take it. Michael Ricketts Bernie, it's fair to say, hasn't still made the best of his Borough career so far, but today's the time to be a hero, isn't it?
No better time. Cup final.
How do you eat sweets and do commentary in a cup final? The multi-talented Bernard Joseph Slavin is Chaskalainen out of the penalty area with his right foot, and Cadre responds to win that one in the air. Just to underscore, as the ball goes out, Simply Red phone in, will open the lines 09147 2000 as soon as the full time whistle blows, unless we're going to extra time or penalties. You can email us, simplyred@centurevm.co.uk. You can text 85102. Gareth Southgate, but it's in the box now, and Ehiog for George Boateng, who again is putting in an industrious performance. He's having a great season, George Boateng. Looks for Janino. Janino takes on the first bounce, but Ngoti won that one with a header. Now, Emerson Tome tries to spread the play to the right-hand side. Pedersen gets a touch. The substitute, Henrik Pedersen, and Mark Schwarzer.
Very ambitious start.
Comfortably behind it. Walks out towards the edge of the box. Just the story of the game, because I know people are cheering into Century during the course of the afternoon. Click on Middlesbrough's official website, www.mfc.co.uk. Just a job in the second minute. Zenden penalty in the seventh minute. Midway through the half, Kevin Davis bringing Bolton Wanderers back into it. We haven't had a goal since then. We've had plenty, though, of excitement. And Henrik Pedersen coming in field. Campo, Diokaev tries to stab the ball into the path there of his number four, but instead it's Burr on the counter charge. It's Mendieta leading the charge. Gaiska Mendieta deep into Bolton territory. What a run this is by Mendieta. Looks for Janino. Janino inside the area. Oh, the angle is going against Janino. Tries to chip the ball in. Did it take a deflection? No, it goes out of play.
I thought he was going to pull the trigger. His left foot couldn't get his ball, his foot rather, wrapped around the ball.
It was a tremendous piece of play by Mendieta. He ran yards and yards, but Janino, unfortunately, the angle just always seemed to be going against him, didn't it, there? As 70 minutes have been played of the Carling Cup Final 2004, so 20 minutes left. George Boateng doesn't get in the centre circle, it's Diokaev instead, to the left, and the longer we go with Middlesbrough advantage, the more risks Bolton will have to take, but here's Diokaev, not a good ball. Kadre, Zenden, that's composed. Yeah, look at Mendieta again, he's getting space on the right.
I don't know if it's composure or stupidity. All that was play was through the middle, and we give away a careless ball.
Yeah, Dorivar it was. Rather unlike Dorivar to give the ball away. Pedersen curls in the box. Mills tries to rise for that one. Diokaev.
Danny did enough.
The flare. Yes, he did.
Just a wee nudge to knock him off his stride there, Diokaev.
And we've said in the build-up to the game, Bernie, I've listened to you on the three legends splendidly as always, with Super Mac and with Katie. They're back tomorrow from 6 and 09 on 70,000. About in critical games, you look around you, and Gareth as captain will look around, and Ugo, England international, Danny Mills, England international, George Boateng, of course, Dutch international, Bolo Zenden, international. There's international players all over the pitch for the Borough. This is what you need in a big game. Dorivar, centre circle, to Gaiska Mendieta. Janino makes a run. Mendieta tries to find him. Instead, it's cleared by Emerson Tome. Gareth Southgate comes right up from the back to win a header, but it's Emerson Tome. Another central defender now for Bolton to the right-hand side, and the substitute, Henrik Pedersen, coming in field. He's 30 yards out from goal. He plays it to JJ Okocha. Okocha picks a pace. Oh, Mealy runs into Dorivar. Dorivar does really well. Now Janino. Janino, a square ball for Gaiska Mendieta. On the halfway line, Mendieta. Looks up. What are the options? There's Ricketts ahead of him to his right, Danny Mills. Mills then. Play it to me, says Michael Ricketts. Ricketts trying to go on the run. Stumbles over. And that's going to be a nothing more than a chance for Bolton to put further pressure on and lay a long ball at the path of Kevin Davis. Gareth Southgate wins ahead. Diokaev picks a pace. Ehiog. Immaculate challenge.
Great lunging tackle.
Now Janino. Through one. Couldn't get through the second. Butter on the halfway line, though.
Scrap your last 10 minutes.
It has. Nerves probably, Bernie, are starting to tell.
There's fatigue.
Dorivar. And still Middlesbrough have other attacking options if they want to use on the bench. Macaroni and Downing.
Your ball's going astray from both teams.
Well, people do get a little bit tired, as you say, nerves. And that looked like handball by Diokaev. George Boateng had won it anyway. Bernie's already thinking about his South Cleveland Garage's man of the match, with Citroen simply the best. I'll ask his nominations in about 9 minutes' time.
Yeah.
As the second half moves on.
They're telling, Sam Allardyce is telling Franson to switch wings with Diokaev.
Good spot, Bernie.
So they're going to try something different.
Danny Mills takes the free kick, right-footed, and Bolo Zenden near side. Jump for it, didn't get really near it, but the ball goes out anyway. And I think it's a Middlesbrough throw. Yes, the referee spotted the merest of touches, I think, of Kevin Nolan. There's an appeal by the Bolton players. The referee has seen the touch, and a Middlesbrough throw it's going to be. And Bolo Zenden's going to take it. The end of the stadium, packed with Borough fans. Banners declaring their allegiance to Middlesbrough, coming from just about all corners of our region, it seems, and beyond. Sing your hearts out for the lads is the cry as Bowler Zenon takes a short throw. Gets it back again. Nutmegs or tries to nutmeg his opponent. Juninho is looking to help. Zenden, all a bit scrappy, but Zenden comes in. Either that was a free kick and the referee, Mike Riley. And Juninho wanted to take a quick free kick. Referee says no, from the wrong position. I don't mind you taking a quick free kick, says Mike Riley, but at least get it within 10 yards from where the offence took place. So, Ubeyog walks forward. Michael Ricketts is in the box. Juninho, the edge of the area. Gais Gamendieta puts the ball down to take this free kick. He's got Kudre ahead of him and Gareth Southgate. I've seen them practice this move on the training ground. They'll pretend to converse, Southgate and Kudre, then they'll walk towards the far side of the box and then they will split apart now. Free kick, Mendieta. Spun in Mendieta. Oh, the goalkeeper gets it on the line. And Jaskalainen collected it. I think, in truth, Mendieta overplayed that, Bernie. It was supposed to be towards either Kudre or Southgate. Instead, it remains 2-1 to the Borough, and the clock ticks ever onwards. Zenden, Gareth Southgate, first touch, Kudre on his heels, but nonetheless, Zenden Borough pushed back into their own half at the moment, inside the box, Schwarzer with his right foot, just about gets into the halfway line where Campo tries to get it under control. Mendieta on his heels, Campo though to the right-hand side. Wanderers trying to switch the play now, Davis with a header, but... Well, you just saw that Kevin Hill had come too close there to Kevin Davis. So Danny Mills then, right back area with his left foot, though, up towards the halfway area where Mendieta thought he got a nudge, but Mendieta comes in field now with possession. Ricketts wanted it playing on first time. Mendieta, though, for George Boateng. Boateng, oh, lovely little piece of play there by Boateng. Skips away, and then along the far side. What a terrific run by Boateng. And a great strides there, and gets a throw-in for Borough deep into Wanderers territory. Gary, what's the thought of the boss at the moment?
We're just, Steve Round, just out having a little bit of a shout there to get out there, lads, and keep it going, because it seems to have sort of settled down a little bit. So I'll tell you what, this game has made for Stuart Downing. A bit of pace, and I'll tell you what, I think you'll tear Bolton apart.
Thanks, Gary. Now, Michael Ricketts. Didn't get there on the leap. 72,634 the attendance in this, what is an indoor arena now. The roof closed at the request of the Football League. It really does add to the atmosphere, even though it's a glorious February day outside. And Danny Mills on the right side. Will Borough be heading for glory? Mendieta, Juninho, back to Gaithka, Mendieta. Mendieta on a terrific charge. Mendieta still with possession. Oh, lovely skill by Gaithka Mendieta. Peel him apart like a Spanish onion. Juninho floats in the box, looks for Ricketts. In fact, Mendieta might get there. Oh, and it just wouldn't break for him, and it goes out. And oh, the referee, I thought that was a clear corner. Old Mother Riley's pointing his fist there is towards the goal kick. He hadn't got a clue. The bloke with the flag over there didn't either, for that matter.
A lovely bit of skill initially from Mendieta.
Great.
The defender put it back in. The defender wasn't clear. As he turned to hit the clear of the ball, Mendieta was on him.
I think Mendieta's had a terrific second half.
Yeah, he has. He's coming on his own second half.
Campo. Mendieta tries to put pressure on him. Bolton Wanderers on the left, cutting in field. It remains 2-1 to the Borough, and it remains a finely balanced Carling Cup final. Who will be getting the glory? Who will be getting UEFA Cup football next season? Danny Mills. Mills under pressure. Mills has to win that tackle, and Mills did win that tackle.
Yeah, he did want to recover, Danny, because his first touch let him down.
I think both players are down injured. While they receive some treatment, let's go down to Gary, because I think, Gary, there's going to be another Bolton Wanderers substitute.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be Javi Moreno coming on. I've got a feeling it might be Yuri Djorkaeff coming off, but I'm not 100% sure.
Thanks, Gary. That means they really would be going for it in every sense, because up front then would be Henrik Pedersen, also up front would be Javi Moreno and Kevin Davis. They will just literally throw everybody forward.
You have to throw caution in the wind. There's still a goal down, and there's not been a lot of goal mouth incidents in the second half. We've been fairly flat, a lot of duty fatigue. And let's hope we can hang on in there.
Still there's treatment being given in the area away to our right-hand side. I don't think, no, it hasn't. The substitution hasn't taken place as yet. I suppose big Sam Allardyce has just been waiting to see if Kevin Nolan is OK. Well, it looks like he's going to be OK. And certainly Javi Moreno is all set to come on now. The fourth official indicating to the referee that Wanderers want to make a sub. Let's pop down to Gary, because it looks like the board's going to flash at any moment now that Moreno's going to come on, guys.
It looks like Javi Moreno will be coming on. Yeah, it's just who that is going to take off with all the noise and everything. The referee's just having a word with Yuri Djorkaeff and one or two of the players, just to try to say, calm him down. And the assistant referee's trying to get attention of old Mother Riley for a substitution.
It seems if Kevin Nolan...
Kevin Nolan, that'll be coming off. Yes.
Yeah. Kevin Owens gone up. Javi Moraes, come on. So Moreno, Pedersen and Davis will go up front now for Bolton. They'll play three up there, you would imagine. And a 2-1 down Bolton, they're going to go for it. As Mark Schwarzer has possession of the ball. Or rather, the referee has possession of the ball. It's going to be drop ball inside the centre circle. And Janino, well, the ball didn't bounce. So it can't be a drop ball, says Mike Ryland, until he just at least hit the floor. Now it does, and Mendieta couldn't get there as Okocha wins possession. Bolton Wanderers on the left-hand side. Middlesbrough without a trophy in the long history. Bolton haven't won one since 1958. So both clubs in need of some silverware, but our need is greater. Cadre then, on the left-hand side of play. Cadre gets his heels clipped there, and that's going to be a free kick. Bernie continues to think. About the next minute, Ben, I'll be asking if you're candidates for the South Cleveland Garage Man of the Match with Hyundai simply the best, so get your thinking cap on. And left-hand side, Zenden. Pass out towards the right for Gaithka Mendieta. Well, I think he's had a terrific second half. Danny Mills. Michael Ricketts couldn't get that one. The ball's gone out of play. And the Borough bench are still just contemplating events. No sign of any further sub from the Borough. As the long ball is laid up towards Kevin Davis, Ehiog wins the header. But here come Bolton again on the left-hand side of the Middlesbrough penalty area. A bit of danger building up here. There's a chance to cross the ball. Boateng's trying to deny that. Still George Boateng. And Javi Moreno getting his first touch near the corner flag. And Danny Mills clears it, but merely finds JJ Okocha. Midway inside the Middlesbrough. Freiferud whizzes it in. Ehiog with an immaculately timed clearance. Mendieta leaps and tries to get it from Okocha. Okocha wins that one, though. Bolton try to keep the pressure on once more on their left-hand side. Okocha onto the run, far side of play. Mills blocks him. Mills goes again.
It's a rugby challenge.
Yes, it is. It's a free kick.
Yeah, and it's a dangerous position. It's outside left.
Well, Middlesbrough protesting. Look at this, Bernie. Bolton have thrown everybody forward.
Got a lot of big lads on there.
Would you be tempted, bear in mind, Junior isn't the biggest, to say, stand on the halfway line, inside your own half, we'll thump it up to you?
Yes, give you an outlet. But Steve McClam doesn't go that way all season. He's played with every red shirt in the box.
And it makes for a crowded box. Ivan Campos pushing around there. Portsmouth nil, Newcastle 1. Craig Bellamy in the Premiership. Right-footed free kick into a crowded area. Campo half got there. Sending. Oh, he got clattered in the back there. And that, oh, Kevin Davis, I felt that up here. Michael Ricketts is making the point. Kevin Davis left his knee in the small of the back of Bolo Sending. And
Davies,
I thought that was awful.
Davies as a centre-forward had to go for it. The ball was hanging in the air. He swung his right boot, missed the ball, connected with Sending. Definitely not a free kick. It's a free kick, but it's definitely, there was no malice in it.
Bolo Zenin felt it very painfully. The Borough fans now away to the left. See, 10 minutes left. You and I, Bernie, at Wembley saw the ribbons on the cup in 97. We're not counting anything, no chickens until they're firmly home to roost here.
Exactly.
But your candidates for the South Cleveland Garage's man of the match with Suzuki simply the best?
I think defensively have been solid again as a back four. In midfield, Boateng, Deriva worked their socks off. Mendieta and flashes, Janino and flashes, Joseph Jobin who's on. There's a lot of candidates out there, but we got off to a glorious start, didn't we?
Yep, terrific start. 2-1 it is, if you just tune into Century. The tension in the voice tells us that it is still a finely poised cup final. Gary, I'll go back to you because Bolo Zenin still seems to be feeling the effects of that knock from Kevin Davis.
That's right, yeah. He didn't have to take a big kick in the back and he's up, he'll want to carry on. But as the law states, he has to go off the pitch to be allowed to come back on.
As Zenin walking off very gingerly. Steve Gibson, who's wearing the same tie as the team. But will he be tickled pink at the end?
Let's hope he is.
The Borough fans saw their chairman's face there on the electronic boards and they yelled and shouted. They love the chairman, love what he's done for the club. 10 years as chairman. Really has been magnificent stuff. A real roller coaster ride for Middlesbrough Football Club. Free kick though for Bolton. And long ball, and that's offside. So just a little reminder that what is going to happen here, if it ends 90 minutes for the Borough at 2-1. They will have won the Carling Cup, then the presentations, then we open the lines 0191 477 2000 for the Simply Red phone-in, and Simply Red with Court Homemakers, 15 years at the top of the league for home improvements. We're still biting our nails. I know everybody listening back in the northeast cheering on Middlesbrough, hoping they can do it. Mark Schwartz's clearance. Emerson Tom, though, merely finds Juninho now. Juninho, Pagaiska, Mendieta. Mendieta glides it towards Michael Ricketts. Offside Ricketts. His header was straight into Traskalainen's grateful arms anyway.
It was offside, but nevertheless, it was a team effort, wasn't it?
It was.
Good ball from Mendieta.
Traskalainen down the pitch. The three-man Bolton strike force. Ehyogun meets the challenge. George Boateng with an acrobatic lead. And now it's Ricketts. Ricketts towards Juninho. Juninho striding forward. Juninho's got to run about halfway the pitch. He's in the box. Juninho wide. Oh, the little man nearly did it.
I thought he was going to start cutting inwards. You know, he sort of he was going outwards and outwards. I thought he was going to cut in and have a crack. I mean, to be fair to the defender, he recovered well and maybe he forced him wide. But it was from an acute angle, missed a target.
Juninho was on the charge. It couldn't be converted. Campo now on the halfway line for Bolton Wanderers. Diokaev slides in. As Mark Schwarzer watching anxiously in the penalty area. Campo now, 35 yards out from goal. Right-footed ball. Looks for Diokaev, right-hand side of play. Diokaev brings it down. A right-footed cross, curled towards the far side of the penalty area. Danny Mills tries to get him. Oh, Gareth Southgate, a timely interception. Just got it away. And Mendieta tries to get the Juninho as well, but Okocha. Borra are camped back inside their own half at the moment. Two banks of red. Chipped into the box now. Half cleared. Gareth Southgate tries to get there. Still far side of the area. Bolton look to put the pressure on. And it's Javi Moreno with Danny Mills at his heels. Moreno back a few yards. And Simon Charlton, his left foot, merely hits the back of Mendieta. And again, there are opportunities to break. Juninho. Juninho now. Oh, he just couldn't find it.
Mendieta. Mendieta was away.
But the ball had gone out. And Mendieta still away, but it can get it. And look at the number three there, Simon Charlton. Oh. Well, he's just wandering down the pitch with the ball. Juninho decides, OK, then let's leave it. 5 minutes left. Can your nerves stand it at home? Can yours, Bernard Joseph? He's quiet. I thought he passed out for a minute. There was a heck of a clump. I thought he hit the floor. And Danny Mills to take the throw along the line. Michael Ricketts is going to move on after this one. Michael Ricketts.
Mendieta's on.
Yes, he is. Ricketts, though, tries to hold it up for a moment or two. Close to the corner flag for Juninho. Juninho's got George Boateng square. Boateng. Oh, tried to thread through the needle for Juninho. Still Borra have it, edge of the box.
That's a wasted opportunity.
Campo.
Look at Campo. You always get a chance with Campo.
Oh, and Dodiva went in. What a free kick. Benny, sorry, your candidates, this Southampton Grange is man of the match. There's so many.
Defensively sound midfield. There's been real battling performances in there. Flashes of skill from Mendieta Juninho.
Let's leave that decision, though. As Borra defend. And it's Gareth Southgate who just got there. But he got there so well. Sender. Dodiva thumps it down the pitch. Mendieta's he shouldn't have gone. He shouldn't have gone because as soon as
Mendieta
he did, he's active. Mendieta should have gone. There's a Bolton player, Gary, down here. There's a Wanderers player down flat out. It looks like he's been
pollaxed. Yeah, somebody's gone over the scene to see, and he's drawn the attention to the referee. And this could be more added extra time on while we get more attention for some of the players. But the tension is building just down by the Borough fans. And they're just absolutely biting nails, biting toenails. They're just biting anything. I'm sure the chairs will go for giving them a chance.
It was Nicky Hunt who was down injured. A free kick for Bolton again inside the centre circle. Again, every red shirt is back defending. And Gotti takes it. And the referee has spotted something. He's jogging backwards towards the... I think it's his fourth official over there who's coming onto the field, having something to say. And that is absolutely...
Frank...
No, I'm going to say pathetic from Nicky Hunks. He's patting Frank Cadreau on the head in a childish manner.
Frank's had a tiff there.
Well, Frank is having a little bit of a word. Now the referee's blowing the whistle and he's going to call somebody towards him.
That'll be Frank, is it?
Well, no, he's just saying get on with things. And Gotti takes the free kick. Mark Schwarzer decides to come for it. Gets his fist to it. It was crowded. There was a scramble. It's a Borough free kick. And pressure has been relieved. Bolo Zen and Frank Cadreau give the high fives. And it's a free kick, though. Tiokiev rather sarcastically puts the ball down, says to Mark Schwarzer, come on, get on with it. If you're counting at home, I make it we've got 3 minutes. There's a lady in front of me who can't look. Well, it's 2-1, and all of Teesside has been waiting a long time. Let's go down to Gary. The final change from Big Sam Allardyce is what, Gary?
Yeah. Giannakopoulos is coming on, and it looks like it's Nicky Hunt going off.
So this really is throwing the entire... Thank you, Gary. Throwing the entire kitchen sink at it, because Stelios, Pedersen, Moreno and Davis, all strikers. Diokaev and JJ Okocha. Sam Allardyce knows it really is gamble time now. For Borough, can they counter? Can they get the third goal? And it's Janinho, middle inside the Wanderers' half. He decides to run at them. This is Janinho. Janinho's going alone. Janinho, terrific piece of skill. Janinho, Mendy, hit it, please. Oh, it just goes out of play for a corner. Janinho then was weaving his magic. And unfortunately, Mendieta couldn't finish.
I thought Janinho was going to let go himself. He did brilliantly. Danced in for the left. He left about three white shots in his wake. And he played it lovely to Mendieta. Should have hit it first time. Took an extra touch, opportunity had gone.
2 minutes left, Borough League 2-1. The Carling Cup final of 2004.
Keep the ball out there.
And they're keeping it close to the corner flag. And Zenden...
Keep it out there in the corners, frustrate them.
A throw-in, ticking down now towards the final 60 seconds, plus whatever stoppage time Mike Riley will decide to add on. And a throw-in up from the corner flag. As it's taken short, Zenden bobbles it on his knee. Wanderers know they need to get the other end, but out of play it goes. And it's a throw-in for Borough again on the right-hand side. Again, the clock ticks down. Again on Century, we said 2-1. Janinho wants to win it. The throw is taken towards the chest of Janinho. Cleared by Wanderers. Danny Mills puts it high. Janinho is now flagged offside. Let's go to Gary. Gary, any sign how long will be added on at the end of the game?
Nothing at this moment, but as we speak, Steve McLaren's just out into the technical area and he's doing his dance as normal and he's just saying, come on, guys, keep the ball, keep it professional, not long to go, let's keep going.
Ehiog, thank you, Gary, wins his header. Mendy had a chase it far side, ball out of play. We're moving now well and truly into the final 60 seconds. Bernie's biting his nails. Nails have been bitten all over the northeast on this Sunday afternoon. Final day of February. Wanderers, though, another attack inside the box. Chance, what a great block that is. And that's a corner. And I think Uga Eyog got in there and just threw everything at it. And Uga Eyog may have stopped extra time with that block. That
fantastic
was terrific.
Fantastic block. Fantastic block.
It's a corner to Bolton, though, to be defended. And again, Borough pull everyone back. In the... Oh, he's gone up there. Jasker Linen's gone forward. The goalkeeper for Bolton. Corner taken by Djokaev, right-footed, crowded area. Ricketts heads it clear. There isn't a goalkeeper down the pitch. Janinho, was he blocked there? Wanderers still put the pressure on. But Mendieta reads it. Oh, Jessica Lyon is way out of his area. Mendieta then, running to the halfway line. Mendieta still with possession, goes to the floor, no free kick.
He should have done it. Janinho.
Mendieta's got to get up. It really is attack and defence here. Ehiog wins the header. Okocha gets it. Okocha then. And Wanderers blocked on the edge of the area. The red shirts performing heroics. Frankie Cadre. Cadre tries to find Janinho right-hand side. Janinho plays in the path of Michael Ricketts. Ricketts, oh, he's hit the goalkeeper with it. He should have put his foot through it.
4 minutes to go, Bert.
Thank you, Gary. Thank you,
Bert. I'm Bernie.
I know you are. We've lost all sense of direction and time here. Janinho on the halfway line. Janinho pulled back. Oh, that was poor stuff by Simon Charlton. Gary, just to confirm it with you, please. 4 minutes?
Yeah, 4 minutes to be added on, and a yellow card given to Simon Charlton for pulling back Janinho, and much deserved there, can I just say.
Gary, what is it like down there, please, with the boss?
Well, we're down there with the boss is just pulling his hair out. He just can't wait for those 4 minutes to be eaten up. The fans are ready. Everybody's ready. Cometh the man, cometh the hour.
I'll tell you what, Ali, looking at the monitor, very lucky he got away with that. The lads hit it, hit Ehiog's left hand.
So short, close range.
No, let's be honest.
Don't either. Chips on offside, Michael Ricketts.
Don't kid the listeners.
No, but if it's that close...
If that was yours, I would have wanted a penalty.
Well, if that's close, you can't say, Bernie, that as Michael Ricketts is going to be yellow carded.
The ball was going goal, wasn't it? He clipped to his left hand.
Michael Ricketts gets the yellow card. Jasker Linen placed the ball down. The referee is saying where to take it from. We're now into the first of the allocated 4 minutes of stoppage time. It is 2-1 to the Borough. Jasker Linen launches the free kick forward. Southgate, on the edge of his own area, wins it. Janinho says, please give it to me. Mendieta, though. George Potang's got a great run.
Like you see Zenden going in a bust. He's Janinho up against Campbell. Get by him, Zenden.
Mendieta.
Zenden.
Infield. Here goes Doriva. Doriva then in the centre circle. Options to the right-hand side of George Potang. Stay onside, please, red shirts. George Potang.
Keep the ball.
Well, Potang's going to try and run it down a little bit there. Then he brings it infield for...
He gives it away.
Mendieta, but Doriva gets it back
they
again.
Do likewise.
George Potang. Potang's going to again go towards the corner flag. Again, try to run down some time, but he's run out of space. It's a throw-in for Bolton on the left-hand side. And once more, it's knocked down the pitch. Davis, though, merely finds Cadre. Frank Cadre. Halfway line area. Frankie Cadre running with it here. The French musketeer on the left-hand side of play. Cadre being caught. That's going to be a free kick. Kevin Davis threw his foot at it. And the Borough fans applauding, yelling, shouting with every decision, which inches this football club closer and closer to the first major silverware in its history. Juninho on the left-hand side. Juninho just keeps it in, but then he's caught fairly. Stelios wins the ball, and Bolton Wanderers on the charge now. They cross the halfway line. Doriva goes to meet Stelios. Stelios gets around in there. The Greek international to the left-hand side. Okocha leading a charge infield for the white shirts. A shot through a crowd. Mark Schwarzer behind it with absolutely everything. Well done, the big Aussie. And we're now 2 minutes away.
But remember, in 97, we were 60 seconds away.
I wish you would shut up, Mark.
Michael Ricketts chases the long ball down the field. Michael Ricketts then. Ricketts, if he could just play it square, Mendy, it was robbed. There. But Michael Ricketts was robbed of possession, as you say, Bernie. Okocha, with his right foot, rakes it out to the near side. Cuadrera tries to get there. It's brought down by Stelios, looks up. Into the area, he'll attack Cuadrera now. And he's still tagging on the up. Oh, Cuadrera just got the challenge.
Did brilliant, Frank, and it had to be crucial.
60
and
seconds.
Timely, otherwise it would have been a penalty kick.
Who said life as a Borough fan was easy? 60 seconds left, 2-1. Middlesbrough lead. The long throw in the box. Gareth Southgate heads it out. Juninho again setting off along the left-hand side of play. Juninho coming in field away from Okocha. Terrific stuff by Juninho. Now he's got Ngoti in front of him. Juninho has got round Ngoti. Come on, Juninho. Oh, he just couldn't beat the last man.
Well, I tell you what, where's Ricketts?
Well,
where is his
Juninho, splendid run. Referee says that is enough. History's been made at the Millennium Stadium. 128 years in the making. 128 years of hurt, but we never stopped believing that we would win a cup, and we have. Bolton 1, Borough 2. The silverware at last is coming to Teesside.
Well, great performance. We walked our socks off from the off. Two glorious goals in the first half. Bolton to the credit, fought back, but who gives a damn? After 128 years, we finally won that elusive trophy. And well done to each and every player. And my thoughts go to Steve Gibson, the chairman, and obviously manager Steve McLaren and his backroom staff. Absolutely brilliant.
It's 2-1. And now, after the word, Middlesbrough Football Club, can be added an extra one. And that word is winners.
And we're in Europe. Not bad, is it? Not a bad day's work.
Let's go down to Gary. Gary.
Oh, this is absolutely fantastic. The final whistle went. The red part of the stadium just went nuts. Everybody up. This flag's been waved. It's just an absolutely fantastic atmosphere down here. Paul Barron, goalkeeping coach for Middlesbrough Football Club, ran up and cuddled Mark Schwarzer because that man made three world-class saves to keep Middlesbrough in this game. Yes, he made one rick, but he saved three sure goals. And I tell you what, it's a crowd. I've never seen anything like it. 126 years, and we're bringing the Carling Cup back to Teesside.
Marvellous stuff. Gary down there with the players. Bernie, your South Cleveland Garage's Man of the Match Awards.
I mean, it's just unfair. There were so many good performances out there. I would like to give it to Joseph Job, because without Job, first goal, getting the penalty kick, and I thought he worked at one straight as Job. He's did it throughout the season, and I thought Joseph Job, I'm going to give it to him. He made one and scored one, and we've won the cup for the first time in 128 years.
Marvellous stuff. Frank Cuadrera walking around there and waving and yelling and shouting. The Middlesbrough players on the pitch. A banner has been unfurled. Steve Gibson, Lord of the Riverside. Great stuff indeed. And now everywhere away to the left is a sea of red and white. This really has been a long time coming. 1876, Middlesbrough Football Club was formed. In those days, Queen Victoria was still on the throne.
I tell you what, we must have won the cup. Alex Smith smiling. I've seen him.
Everybody is hugging, and Mark Schwarzer and Juninho embrace. 2-1, the full-hand score. The officials now on the pitch just putting everything in place. One or two Bolton fans moving towards the exits. But, Bernie, just before we dwell on the triumph that belongs to Teesside, that belongs to Steve Gibson and his vision, just a brief word about Sam Allardyce and his players. They gave the cup final everything, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. I thought it was an exciting cup final. It was end-to-end stuff. The last 20 minutes, I think, is a spectacle that fell away. Both teams were suffering from fatigue, and it showed, you know, there was some sloppy passes. But I thought they gave a good account of themselves, Bolton, because they made a game of it 2-0 down. They could have quite easily folded. They got a goal back. And then Drogheva, as we mentioned, the first half could have scored a couple of goals on his own. But nevertheless, we've won the trophy, and 10 years' time, they'll forget about the performance or whatever. It's, we've won a trophy, we're in Europe. Where do you think we'll end up in Europe?
Let's go back down to Gary before the presentations. Gary, sum up what the mood is like amongst the Borough fans and players.
Absolutely fantastic. The Borough players are just milling around. I don't think they can believe it after them. You can imagine what the melee is like here with press and the cameras and everything. Steve Harrison just looking over, and the management team are sort of just sitting back, letting the players enjoy the day. And they're just, as we speak, they're constructing the platform which the players will go on to receive. Yes, receive the Carling Cup. We've won it, and it is just a fantastic feeling to say that. After all this time, no one can mock us in the Northeast anymore for not winning any silverware. That trophy cabinet down at the Riverside will have a trophy in it. It's called the Carling Cup, and we're going to Europe next season.
Great stuff, and the name Juninho echoing around in 1997. It was tears of despair for Juninho when they lost the League Cup against Leicester City and the FA Cup against Chelsea, and Juninho went to Atletico Madrid, but he's come back. He always said, Juninho, that to win the Carling Cup would mean as much as winning the World Cup. And he can put both in the cabinet now, can't he?
Not bad, is it? Not a bad collection. World Cup, Carling Cup. Now, the wee man's deserved it. I mean, this season he's been brilliant. It's his third stint in Teesside. And I believe him when he says that, you know, he'd compare it with his World Cup medal. I believe him.
One Stevie Gibson echoing round. And when you think this is the 10th year of Steve Gibson's reign as chairman of Middlesbrough Football Club, he had the vision to take the team and the club from Essen Park to the Riverside. He's backed his managers with cash to make signings. And at last, he is here. And he's going to see it. And he will enjoy it, Steve Gibson. But probably he deserves to enjoy it a little bit more than your average fan, because our average fan is also the chairman. And well done to Steve Gibson for your vision and for bringing the cup home. Gareth Southgate, down to you, Gary. Gareth's going to punch the air, yes?
What he does at every home game, he's punching the air. The delight on his face is magnificent. And responding is every single Borough fan, waving a flag, waving a scarf. It means a lot to Gareth Southgate. He's a passionate man. Flags being thrown onto the pitch, scarves being thrown onto the pitch. Hugo Ekiol goes down to see the fans as well. And the fans are enjoying this. We've waited an awful long time to get some success at Teesside. It's finally come, and they're going to ring every minute out of this. They're not going to let this pass over quickly. This is going to go on for weeks, months, years even. They thoroughly enjoyed it. But Gareth, on his face, you can see the man's a true captain, a true leader of men. He's out there wearing his heart on his sleeve. It is absolutely brilliant to see. And every single player out there, you can see it on their faces. They really, really wanted this. And they're 100%, 100%. And they're just looking forward to pick that trophy up and getting their medals.
0-9-1-4-7-2000, the Simply Red phone in. We've opened the lines now to accept your calls, please. Middlesbrough Football Club fans, your team are winners. Give us a call. Simply Red phone in with Court Homemakers. 15 years at the top of the league for home improvements. Email simplyred@centurym.co.uk or send a text to 85102. Presentations about to take place. The Borough players away to the left. Frank Cadre just waving again to the fans. Frank showing his delight. Everybody doing that. And I think the award, first of all, will go to Bolton Wanderers as runners-up of the competition. And then it will go to the Borough and for Gareth Southgate to end all of those years waiting to finally win it. In the end, Bernie, as they put the final piece to the centre stage and we're about to do the presentations, in the end, what did win it for Middlesbrough Football Club?
I think there was an element of luck there, as in penalty kicks. When it comes to penalty kicks, it becomes a bit of a lottery. But hey, we beat three Premiership outfits on the way. We beat Everton, we beat Tottenham Hotspur down at White Hart Lane, and then we went and beat Arsenal down at Highbury, and then we beat them at the Riverside. So all in all, we thoroughly deserve to come through to the final. And on the day, we were still the better team.
Okay, let's...
We're
not in the presentation any moment now, but let's pop down to Gary. Gary, you with all the Borough fans?
That's right, yeah, we're down with the Borough fans. I've got a guy in front of me here. How much have you wanted that?
For 71 years.
And you're just taking in every moment of it?
I am, yeah.
Exciting game, wasn't it?
It was great, yeah. It was a bit unfortunate with their goal, but
But wonderful to see the trophy come back to Teesside.
It's never been. You've forgotten that. Yes, I've supported them since 1944, and this is great.
It's better than getting married, isn't it?
Steve!
Back to you, Ali.
Thanks, Gary. Presentation party is now making its way towards the plinth, and the presentation will take place fairly shortly. The Carling Cup trophy. Mark Hunter, the Marketing and International Development Director of Coors Brewers Limited. I'll be joined by Andy Williamson, the Director of Operations of the Football League. And Thomas Coyle, he'll also be there as well, who's the great-grandson of Alan Hardacre. He will be presenting the Alan Hardacre Man of the Match trophy. So, a few presentations to take place. The awards now have been brought out there, and the Middlesbrough fans just enjoying Burnley.
And are you watching Newcastle? And I hope yous are. And especially you, McDonald.
You can speak to him tomorrow on the Legends. Mike Riley, the match official, walks up. He awarded bravely that penalty in the 7th minute that Paulo Zenin converted. And he receives his medal, along with the other officials this afternoon. So Mike Riley and his team, they're receiving their mementos now of their part in the Carling Cup final 2004. And now we're going to have Bolton Wanderers, I think, to come forward. And JJ Kotcher is going to lead Bolton forward to receive their losers' medals. He slips a little bit on the walkway up towards the presentation area. But Gary, down to you briefly. Bolton have played their full part today, haven't they?
They certainly have. They've made a very exciting game of it. And the fans, the Bolton fans, have been magnificent as well. Not as good a voice as the Borough fans, but hey, they've certainly made this spectacle into a day. And I'll tell you what, people listening at home must have thoroughly enjoyed it, because it was just an entertaining game of football. Two sides wanting to win one trophy, and Borough for once becoming the victors.
Gary Phillipson down there. He'll continue to get post-match reaction with Steve Ollis, our touchline reporting team today. The Bolton players coming up, Bruno Ngotti, just noticed Ivan Campo there as well, Yuri Diokayev. It really has been a tough, tough battle indeed. But any moment now, as Sam Allardyce comes up and receives his award as manager of Bolton Wanderers, any moment now, as we say, 0191 477 2000, Simply Red phone in, the lines are open now. You can text 85102. You can email simplyred@centurym.co.uk. Now we're moving into uncharted territory. The lights are going to dim here at the Millennium Stadium.
Not good for my camera, what now?
The uncharted territory we're moving into is a Middlesbrough football team who are going to go forward and in a leap year make a giant leap forward to the football club and accept a major trophy. The lights are flashing all around the impressive Millennium Stadium. The Carling Cup itself under the spotlight with the red and white ribbons. It's been walked forward. And at this moment in time, as a Borough fan over all of the years, wherever you're listening to Century FM, your team have won something. And that makes everybody very, very proud indeed. The players are standing there. In years to come, they'll tell their children and grandchildren of this moment when they were part of the first Middlesbrough football team ever to win something. Any moment now, the roof that's been closed will lift to the noise and the roar of a victorious team from the Borough. And there are many of us who never thought we'd say that. Up they come then. This team is making history. There'll be many great Borough players over the years. Brian Clough, Wolf Mannion, Big John Hickton. But none of them be able to do what these players in red are going to do now. Up come the Borough, led by Bolo Zenin, who got the second and crucial goal. George Boateng is there. What a performance. The French musketeer, Frank Coudreau, receives his winning medal that dangles round his neck. Ugueyov, wonderful performance at the heart of the net, out of the defence. Michael Ricketts, who came on to play his part. Mark Schwartz, who recovered and made some match-winning saves. Gijs Gemendieta, who tormented Bolton in the second half. Doriva, the Brazilian, who worked tirelessly. And up come all of the players to receive their award. Brad Jones is coming up, the sub-goalkeeper. All of the squad have played their part. Everyone, even if you're not part of the presentation party, I feel, for example, for Colin Cooper. A borough lad in every sense of the word who deserved to walk the cup forward. And he's walking out, and Stevie Gibson's going to come out, and he deserves to. Danny Mills is there. The Samba star Juninho, who for a moment, the back of the shirt takes off the name Juninho and puts Teesider, because he's ours, the Samba star. And there'll be many great Middlesbrough captains. George Hardwick, Stuart Baum, Gordon Jones, Tony Mowbray, but none of them have been able to do what Gareth Southgate is going to do now. That's put his hands around a cup and convert after the words Middlesbrough Football Club and add an extra word. And the word is, winners, we've got it! What a moment. The pyrotechnics go up in the stadium, but there are fireworks all over Teesside and in the stadium. The Borough have done it. They are the winners of the Carling Cup for 2004. They're into Europe. And wherever you are, Borough fans, be prepared for the biggest Sunday night party of all. Middlesbrough Football Club, winners of the Carling Cup, are about to take the trophy towards the fans. And I think as well, Chairman Steve Gibson is going to get his hands on it. Steve McLaren has got his hands on it.
Yeah, he has.
Gary, down to you.
Wonderful, wonderful scenes, as you see. The lights all dip, the fireworks have gone off. And I tell you what, when Gareth lifted that trophy, every Middlesbrough fan in the stadium lifted the trophy with him. What a wonderful, wonderful sight to see. And I tell you what, the whole of Teesside will be dancing tonight, whether on Linthorpe Road or you're on Pontop Pike. Get yourself out, you're going to have a top time, because the beer will be flowing tonight in Teesside.
And we walk towards the Borough fans, the way to the left. Kick bag booms out around the Millennium Stadium. Steve Gibson shakes hands with the match referee, Mike Riley. And away go the Borough players towards the left-hand side, the north stand end, which has been the lucky end for many teams. And they're posed to take the photographs that'll adorn tomorrow morning office walls and school walls everywhere on Teesside. And a special word as well for our mascot today, Rebecca Lawrence. You did your job terrifically. You're the mascot of a winning team here at the Millennium Stadium. And Juninho does a little jig, a Brazilian version of the Nobby Styles, for those who remember 66 in the World Cup. But this thing means as much, this Carling Cup, according to Juninho, as the World Cup. Now, all the players gather behind the board that says Carling Cup 2004, right in front of the Borough fans. The champagne is fired everywhere. They're getting drenched, the players, but they're drenched in success. And Gary, again, we switch down to you. You and me are all of that. What's it like down there?
It is. I'm just walking round now to where they just do it, get their photographs taken. The fans are going nuts. There's all sorts going on. People waving flags. We're just going to see if we can get a word with some of the players just after they bring the cup round. I'll see if I can get a touch of the silverware myself. Both with Steve and myself, we'll be working out to get as many interviews as we can, get as much cup reaction on Century FM as much as we can, because this is just a fantastic day for the North East, not just for Teesside, for the whole of the North East.
And somebody drinking out of the cup is Chairman Stevie Gibson.
Cup man.
And Steve Gibson takes a drink, and if anybody deserves a drink out of that cup, it's him.
Well, he's paid plenty for it, hasn't he? Well done, Steve Gibson.
His suit has been drenched, the tie is gone, but he's smiling. And for those of us who remember Steve Gibson, when it all started out as chairman in, 10 years ago now, the vision to take us to a new stadium, the vision to bounce back from the disappointment of getting relegated in 97 and losing a couple of cup finals, but he never stopped believing that one day we would be winners. And winners we are, and Steve Gibson deserves it. The Tony give the South Clayton Garages Man of the Match award to Joseph Chopp. For the other goal scorer, Bolo Zenden's received an award for Man of the Match, the Alan Hardacre award as well. And Bolo Zenden had a terrific game.
Bolo done well. I mean, there was a lot of players that did very well. It's difficult to pick one guy out in a major cup final. But it's not about individuals, it's about collectively. And today we've produced the goods, we've finally ended the hoodoo, and it's been a magnificent day all round. I'd like to say, well done to each and every fan that's travelled down. Travelled in their droves, they've made a great atmosphere here this afternoon. Well done to them as well as the team.
It really is. Party on, Teesside. Gary, just to check where you are at the moment with all the champagne flying. Gary?
Hello, all the champagne flying everywhere. And it just says the Bolton end is just clear now. If there's no Bolton fans left in the stadium, it's all Borough. And just as we talk, Janino's ushering the players to come round to where the fans are. We're going to see if we can get some reaction from some of the players. So just keep listening, of course, because we're trying to get as much reaction as possible.
Thank you, Gary. Well, all of a sudden, this left-hand side of the stadium turns again to a sea of red and white. And Bernie, you've commentated with me on Century for the cup finals that ended disappointment. This is better. We won the thing.
Of course, that's why you're playing finals. Not that the members are runners-up when you actually win the trophy. These guys, each and every one of them, will be down in history of Middlesbrough Football Club. And that is some achievement. Because as you rightly said, over the years, there's been Manning, Clough, yeah, Hardwick, Picton, numerous guys, great players, Ravenelli, never actually won a trophy. But these guys have finally done it, and well done to them.
Everyone deserves credit. They're now going on the lap of honour. Just a reminder, the lines are now open for Simply Red phone in 019-1477-2000. Rod is working to take the calls. With Cordell Makers, 15 years at the top of the league for home improvements. You can email simplyred at centuryofm.co.uk. You can send a text to 85102. The Borough have started their lap of honour. Let's stay with this as we can. They're right in front of where we are at the moment. Janino dancing with a cup. And Frank Gaudreur and Paul Hussein and George Boateng. Tori there. They're all going to do a little bit of a chain, I think, dancing down there at the moment. I suppose they're dancing around Albert Park and down in Thorpe Road. And they will for many days to come. Janino leading the run towards the Borough fans. And Gary, it's right in front of you, the Carling Cup now. Taste it, touch it.
Yeah, it's right there in front of us. Janino's got, he's got the cup, George Boateng's there. Unbelievable. After French.
Great stuff. Gary's down there.
Bolo, treble.
Quick, oh yeah, that's
Gary. Yeah, I've got Bolo standing with me now. Bolo. Oh, what a wonderful feeling.
Absolutely great. Look at the fans down there. It's unbelievable.
It's just great, great atmosphere in here. Wonderful stadium. But to take a trophy home after 126 years, just magnificent.
I couldn't be better.
Thanks, Bolo. Cheers.
Great stuff. Gary there with Bolo Zenon. And the Borough players right in front of their supporters, milking the moment, enjoying it. And Uwe Jog, I think he's the final one of the players round. Gary and Steve Ullis will get considered post-match reaction. I think they're reluctant to leave at the minute, the players, and every right to
enjoy
leave slowly. Enjoy it, because winning moments don't come along very often.
They don't. Certainly not if you play for Middlesbrough. It's been proven after 128 years.
Let's hope it's not at 128 years before we can say it again. Well, you and I wouldn't be saying it again. Gijs Gemendieta is down there. He's waving a wave. He won the Spanish Copa del Rey with Valencia. He's now with his hands on English silverware, the Carling Cup with Middlesbrough. Gareth Southgate in the corner with all the fans. Let's switch back down to Gary if we possibly can. Gary, I know you're amongst the throng of it all, but these are the pictures that really will make it tomorrow morning on the back pages and the front pages, certainly in Teesside.
They certainly will. They'll be on the whole of the nation. It is just a wonderful feeling. The players are just so happy. It's unbelievable. I've got a quick word with Bolo there. He just wants to get on and celebrate. He's just had a fantastic time. And a lot of the players are. They're just desperate to sort of to get taking as much as they can. These people have won cups all over the world. They've World Cup winners on there. And this is something really special for them because it means a lot to the people that support them. They've not had silverware at Middlesbrough and they know that. So this one's for the actual fans.
Thanks, Gary. Gary's staying down there with the players. Just to remind you again, 019-1477-2000. We're opening the lines right now for a very special Simply Red phone-in. We're going to take you right the way through until 5 o'clock.